get on the comments. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum, Maryam.
Assalamu alaikum,
Ahmed.
Wa alaikum assalam.
And assalamu alaikum to the rest of you. I want to start by making a few announcements. The first of them is that you will notice that there is a, you know, an address at the bottom of the screen that's always going to stay there. That is for all the study materials. So those of you that ask questions about that, now you have the permanent answer to that. So, you know, that's all that's going to stay there, because some of you, you know, catch on later on or you got it wrong. So I'm just going to keep that at the bottom for a while. The other announcement that I'd like to make is for those of you that are studying this course with us and they have kids with them. So if you do have kids with them, I'd like you to send me a picture or a video of you guys studying together. And, you know, even if you can recite something for me, like Bataka Flam, Wa min fi an ala hatta illa, and inna annaka anna lita lakin la'alla, and tell me your names, I would appreciate it, because I'd like to give some of you shout outs during the class too. Because we want, you know, I've been teaching the internet and you guys got weird screen names like Doctor. So, you know, or Jigsaw. There's a Jigsaw taking the class. So, you know, so I'd like to see what, you know, how human Jigsaw is in reality. So, you know, you guys can send me that, because I do want to kind of get a sense of who's out there, right? Are these Russian bots, or is it actually people that are learning Arabic with us? So I asked you to do your homework, which yesterday was pretty simple. All you had to do was review what I asked you to memorize. Yes. They were the group of harf called the harf of jar, and another group of harf called the harf of nasr. Maryam, would you like to kick things off?
Okay.
And those would be the harf of... Good. What would be the harf of nasr?
Inna anna kanna bi anna laita lakinna la'alla.
Brilliant.
Bata kaflam wawmin fi an ala hata ila.
Okay.
Inna kanna bi anna. Inna anna kanna. Lakinna la'alla. Bi anna.
Start over. Relax.
Bata kaflam wawmin.
No, no, no. You got the harjat. I need the harf nasb.
Inna anna ka'anna bi anna layta lakinna la'alla.
Brilliant. You got it. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so that's a big thing. Having you guys having memorized that makes my job a lot easier, because now I get to build on that for you and really help you understand what's going on. When we started early on, I told you that something like, this is where I want to start today, building on what we did yesterday, and then we'll take some notes. You said Muslimun is an ending sound.
Yes.
And Muslimani is a combination. Two Muslims. That's two rafa, right? Muslimaini, you know, in the beginning I told you it's two nasab or two jar. Right?
Yeah.
Right? But now what I can say is, if I said inna, right?
Yeah.
And then I said al-Muslimaini. Right? Now, here in the top line, it's Aini, which means two nasab or jar, right? And here it's again Aini, which you learn to say is two nasab or jar.
Yeah.
But now you don't have to say, or you're not allowed to say two nasab or jar. You have to pick one of them.
Yeah.
You have to pick one of them. Which one are you going to pick in this case?
Jar.
No.
No, nasab.
Nasab.
Oh, nasab.
Yes, you know why? Because inna, the one you memorized, is from the harf of?
Nasab.
If it's from the harf of nasab, and then the next word, I don't know if it's nasab or jar, it's definitely nasab.
Yeah.
If the word before was a harf of jar, and I don't, let's say if I said fil muslimaini, fi al-muslimaini. The aini is still aini, because that works for two nasab or two jar, but this time the answer would be two jar for sure. Why? Because there's a harf of jar before it. So when we started off, we said something could be nasab and could be jar.
Yeah.
Now we're getting a little better at that, and we can be more accurate. We know when it's nasab and we know when it's jar. Same thing if I say, for example, baytu muslimaini. Muslimaini, right? Baytu is light and doesn't have al.
So it's jar?
Well, no. You're forgetting the other lesson.
Oh.
When a word is light and doesn't have al,
it is a mudaf.
Right. And the only way you can prove that is if you find a mudaf ilayh. Is the next word possibly jar?
Yeah.
Aini could be nasab or jar. Well, in this case, because you have a mudaf and you have a mudaf ilayh, that's why you don't say nasab or jar anymore. You have to say jar. Okay, so there's two kinds of jar. Jar because there was a mudaf and it became a mudaf ilayh.
Yeah.
Or jar because it was a harf of jar. Jar, like that. Because of B, the harf of jar. So there's two kinds of, they're both jar, but they're jar for different reasons. Okay, this jar is called the mudaf ilayh. You already know that.
Yeah.
The guy that comes after the mudaf and could be jar, mm-hmm. is mudaf ilayh.
Yeah.
This one, the one that gets beat up by a harf of jar, that's called a majroor. That's a new word for you today.
Majroor.
Okay. The harf of jar is called, the harf of jar, another word for it is jar. Can you say that?
Jar.
It's like double R. Jar.
Jar.
Jar. That's triple R. Jar.
Jar.
Yeah, a little bit. Roberto, like that. Jar.
Jar.
That's like the start of a motorcycle. Jar. Like just.
Jar.
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 A little less on the, the bullfighting. Yeah. Jar.
Jar.
Yeah, a bit better. Jar. Okay, but the A is longer.
Yeah.
Right? So the harf of jar can be called?
Jar.
And the word that it made jar is called, its victim, who we beat up and made jar, is called the majroor. So basically what I'm trying to say is, if you see something like, wal asri, wal asri, right?
Yeah.
You're going to call this jar majroor. This part is jar, and this part is majroor. Jar majroor.
Jar majroor.
Majroor.
Jar.
Like a jar of jam. You can say jar majroor. I'm okay with that. Jar majroor. This is like jar majroor style. Like it's like so jar and like majroor because a harf of jar like made it jar.
Yeah.
Therefore.
It's majroor.
Yeah. So jar majroor. Yeah.
Jar majroor.
So if I say Kitabullahi, or if I say, Minallahi, right? Mm-hmm. These two examples. Kitabu is light and doesn't have al on it.
Yeah.
That makes it a mudaf. Mm-hmm. So this would be the word kitab is mudaf and the word Allah is mudaf ilayh. In this case, min is one of the words you memorized. It's a harf of jar. No. Harf of haram, Maryam. The harf of nasab are inna anna ka anna bi anna layta lak inna la'alla.
Yeah.
Harf of jar or what? What are they? Is min part of that?
Yeah.
So min Allah would be a case of the min part would be the jar, and the word Allah would be the majroor.
Okay.
That this one's mudaf ilayh, and this one's jar majroor.
Jar.
That's the terms you use. That makes you sound super educated in Arabic. Like if you went to like a sheikh and said, "Kitabullahi is mudaf ilayh."
Yeah.
And minallahi jar majroor.
Yeah.
You'd be like, whoa, no, why don't you lead the prayer? Hey, he can give the khutbah, he knows jar majroor. Oh, hey, it got hot in here in the masjid. That's what's going to happen if, and that's not what you're learning. You could find a sheikh, hey, by the way. Minallahi jar majroor. Right? So, but the point is, this one is Kitabullah is mudaf ilayh, and the words minallahi is jar majroor. Another example, and you tell me the words you would use, right? So, if I say, and ba is a harf of jar, right?
Yeah.
But the word Ibrahim, because it's a non-Arab name, it cannot take the e.
Yeah.
So it's That's why even in jar, it's that. Ibrahim. So what would we call this? Be Ibrahima. Would we call this mudaf ilayh, or would we call this a jar majroor?
We call this, I think, a jar majroor.
Jar majroor. What do you think?
Jar majroor. Yeah.
That would be a jar majroor. Okay. Millah means religion. Millata.
So if, Ibrahim. If like the word comes from the harf of jar, it becomes yar majrur.
Jar majrur. Not yar majrur. Not yar majrur. Jar majrur.
Jar majrur. I'm sorry. I'll get good at it.
You'll get good at it. I know. It's you're just cute at it right now. It's good. It's okay. So milleta, is it light?
Yes.
Yeah, and it doesn't have al.
Yeah.
So that means it might be a
mudaf.
A mudaf. Could Ibrahima be jar?
No.
You guys are still stuck on that.
No. Yes. Oh, it can be.
Because yes. Why? No. I forgot. It's not good enough.
Ibrahima.
Therefore, the full answer is if you mess that up. And you have to explain the whole thing to me this way. Ibrahima is not Arab, which makes it partly flexible, okay. Which means that the rafa ends with
Ibrahimu, Ibrahima.
Nasab ends with
Ibrahima.
And jar ends with
Ibrahima.
So it could be jar.
Yeah.
That's the, I'm saying that, but I want you to get good enough that you say yeah. That, right? So could this be jar?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Totally. So this could be a mudaf and
mudaf ilayh.
So when you saw bi Ibrahima,
that would be.
That was
Jar
Majrur. And when it's Millata Ibrahima?
That's Mudaf and Mudaf Ilayh.
Okay, now listen. Have you ever said Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin kama salaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim wa innaka Hamidum Majid? You know this?
Yes.
Okay. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin. Ala Muhammadin. That's what you memorized.
Yeah.
Okay. Is this something that you've already learned about in this Arabic class?
No.
Really?
Oh, I know. Yeah, we have.
In oh, that,
no.
Is ala a familiar word?
Yeah. Bata.
From where?
From the jar side. The harf of jar, I think.
Prove it to me. Bata, I don't believe you.
Bata, kaf, lam, waw, min, fi, an, ala, al, an.
Ala.
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 When you go through it, I want you to look at the word and go through it.
Because
if you're looking at the sky and going, Bata kafla ma'umin fi ana ala hatta ila, you still don't know which match it was.
Okay.
So look at it and do it, right? Bata kafla ma'umin fi ana ala. I've seen you before. You're ala. I memorized you. You have a place in my heart. Okay. Now, ala would be a what?
This would be a harf of jar.
Therefore, these two things would be called what?
Jar majrur.
This would be a jar majrur.
Jar majrur.
Jar majrur. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala.
Now when I pray, I'm be like, oh my gosh, it's a jar majrur.
Yep. Then you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin. You say three words. Ala Ali Muhammadin. The ala. You know something about it.
Yeah.
What do you know about
it's
it?
It's a harf of jar.
Good. It's a harf of jar. A harf of jar makes the next word jar. And therefore, Ali is jar.
Yeah.
Right? Because it would have been alu, ala, or ali, and it's ali, it's jar.
Yeah.
What is these two? What are these two going to be called if you're like super PhD Arabic? What
jar you, majrur.
Jar majrur. Which part of it is jar? Which part of it is majrur?
Jar is this guy, ala, and then majrur is this guy.
Yep. This is jar, this is?
Majrur.
Now let me ask you something about Ali.
Ali.
Is this light?
Yes.
Ali, yeah.
Totally. Does it have Al on it?
Yes.
Yes.
Really? Take the Al off. You still have a word left?
No.
No.
Oh.
So it's not light.
Ali.
Does it have Al on it?
Yeah.
No. It has the word is Al. Ali. Is it Al or no. Al?
Al.
You said light, no Al, or did you say light, no Al?
Oh, light, no Al.
Is there al?
No.
No.
If there was al, how would you say this word?
If it was no.
Ali. And then to say this word. Al.
Al-Ali.
That's right. Al-Ali.
Yeah.
So there's actually no al on it. It's kind of tricky. Yeah. Al means family.
Okay.
In Arabic, al means family.
Oh my.
So al. Now, is this light? The question comes back. Is this light and doesn't have al?
Yes.
Totally.
Yeah.
Which means it could be a?
Mudaf,
yeah,
right, mudaf.
Okay.
But how do we prove something is a mudaf?
If it has no al,
mudaf ilayh after it.
Yeah. Right. So first of all, it has no al and it's light. You're right. And then you also have to prove that the next word is
mudaf ilayh.
How do you prove the next word is a mudaf ilayh? So we're looking
it's
at the.
Jar.
Is it?
Din, yeah.
Din Muhammadin's non-Arab.
Muhammad's not Arab.
Muhammad.
Wait, is he? Oh, he.
What is he?
I forgot. I forgot he was there.
How do you forget? He's like the most popular.
Yes, Rasulullah is definitely Arab. He's definitely Arab. So,
it's not Jeb. So it's not.
It's Jeb. Not Jeb.
It is.
It is. Oh, in yes.
In.
I forgot. Yes.
Yes.
Jeb. Yeah.
Just because you see a name, don't go to non-Arab.
Okay.
Right? Arab prophets are Arab. Okay. So Muhammad is an Arabic word. So Muhammadin would be
Jeb.
Which means that Ali is in fact a mudaf, and Muhammadin is in fact a
Jar.
Mudaf ilay. So the labels are Ala is Jar. Ali is majroor, but Ali is also mudaf and mudaf ilayk. Pretty cool. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin. Kama sallayta ala. You're right. Then what? Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin. Kama sallayta ala
Ibrahima.
That's what you memorize.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good. What kind of word is ala?
Ala is a harf of jar.
Good. Ala is a harf of jar. Is the word Ibrahima in fact jar?
Ibrahim. Yeah, because the word, if it's in front of it, it becomes jar. It's jar contagious.
Good, but you're right. It does catch the jar virus. Now the question is, how come this is jar and it ends with ah?
Because Ibrahim is
Ibrahim is not
Maryam,
Arab.
Maryam.
Non-Arab. Yeah.
Non-Arab. Therefore, yes, I need the full explanation.
It could be either nasab or jar, but in this case, because it's jar before, it has to be jar. You choose
right. And notice how even when you memorized it, right, it's so cool that this lesson of what's the difference between partly flexibles and fully flexibles is clear when you say the salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, because you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin, but when you said it on Muhammadin, it was in.
Yeah.
And then in the same line, when it came to Ibrahim, you didn't say Ibrahimin. Right? Yes. So it kind of, you already memorized that there's a difference between those two. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala
Ibrahima.
Then what? So ala Ibrahima would be a what? What's, is this a mudaf mudaf ilay? Ala Ibrahima?
Yeah, this is
Woo!
Well, no, it's Ibrahima is a mudaf mudaf
ilay. No.
The whole thing is.
No.
Yeah, it's not, oh, it's the first one's. Jeb.
Right.
And then Ibrahima is a
mudaf.
No, what is the other name?
Ibrahim.
What was the, I forgot it. Jar Majroor.
Thank you. If you see, listen to me carefully. If you see a harf of jar and then its victim, you never use the words mudaf mudaf.
Okay.
You always use the words jar majroor. Why? Because a mudaf mudaf ilay, both of them have to be isms. The mudaf has to be an ism and the mudaf ilay has to be an ism. But in this case, ala is a harf. It's not an ism.
Yeah.
Remember the three kinds of words in Arabic?
Mm-hmm.
Ism, fi'il, harf?
Yeah.
Ala is a harf of jar.
Yeah.
So it's not even an ism, which means it can never be a mudaf.
Okay.
So when you see two words together, you got to pick which label are you going to use. Are you going to use mudaf, mudaf ilay, or are you going to use jar, majroor? Which one are you going to use in this case? Good, jar majroor. Okay, now, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahima wa ala Ali Ibrahima. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Ala Ali Ibrahima.
It's a harf of jar.
It's a harf of jar. And what's the, if it's the jar, then what's the majroor?
Ali.
Good. Ali is the majroor.
Yeah.
Ali looks like it's a mudaf. Why would I say that? Why would I say such a terrible thing?
Ali, because it has an E, so it becomes a jar.
No, why is... You're right. It's the majroor already. We got that.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I'm saying it might also be a mudaf.
Yeah.
How dare I say that?
Oh, because the word after it could be...
no, that's not... You didn't check for mudafness yet. You're looking for mudaf ilayness already.
Oh, mudaf, because it doesn't have al.
Doesn't have al.
And it's... Wait, if it doesn't have L
and it's a light, or light,
and it's light,
yeah.
Is it light?
Yeah,
because if it was heavy, it would have been
Alin.
Brilliant. So, ala Ali,
yeah,
yeah, mm-hmm. Okay. Could the next word be a mudaf ilay?
Yeah, yes, Ibrahima, because it's partly flexible,
dying,
and it is non Arab, and there's only one Ibrahimu, Ibrahima, Ibrahima. Therefore, if it is jar, the jar contagiousness, so it becomes Ibrahima is jar.
So tell me this. I'm going to highlight these two words, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Tell me what should I say about them. Should I say mudaf? The ones that are gray. Should I say mudaf, mudaf ilay, or should I say jar majroor?
How dare you? It's jar majroor.
Excellent. Maryam, if I highlight these two words, what should I say?
Mudaf, mudaf ilay.
Brilliant. Jar majroor, mudaf, mudaf ilay.
Yeah.
I'm really happy right now. You guys are doing great. Questions online, Jawad? So far?
The one that I'm seeing mostly is, can a phrase be both jar majrur and idaf at the same time?
They can be connected to each other, but they can't be both at the same time, because a harf of jar can never be called a mudaf. So not at the same time, but you're seeing that they can be next to each other and chained together. Yeah, you can have chains. Okay. Rabbil Alameen, we did this before, yeah, but yeah, let's do it again. Okay. Is this a mudaf and a mudaf ilay?
Well, yes.
Process?
Mudaf, Rabbi, it's light and it has no L.
Good.
So we can cut, it's partly there. And then Alameena, it has to be jar, but it's not, because Alameena.
Ina is jar or nasab.
Jar or, oh, so.
So then
yeah,
it would have, if you have a mudaf, you
it
have
becomes
to use jar.
The jar.
If you have
so is it then a mudaf and a mudaf?
Yeah. Yes.
And when the magicians turned to the Pharaoh after believing in Musa alayhi salam, and they said, "Amanna bi Rabbil Alameena," they used the word "bi." Yeah,
bi.
What is the relationship between bi and Rabbi?
Bi and Rabbi, they're both harf of jar.
So what's, they're both? Rabb is not a harf of jar.
Oh no, bi.
So what's the? How do you describe this?
A harf of jar.
No, jar and
majrur.
Jar and majrur.
Yeah.
The B would be the jar, and the rub would be the majrur. And the rub would be the mudaf, and the alamina would be the mudaf. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. Then we did inna. Help me finish this line. Anna.
Inna, anna, ka'anna,
ka'anna, good.
Bi'anna,
bi'anna, good.
Layta,
lakinna,
la'alla.
Lakinna, and?
La'alla, yeah.
Brilliant. Okay, so these are the harf of what?
Nasab.
Nasab. When you saw a harf of jar and its victim, what did you call it? Jar, majrur. When you saw a light, no alif lam, and a jar after it, you called it mudaf and mudaf ilay. These ones, you don't have to, there's no hard terms. It's easy. If it's inna, let's pick each of them, right? If I say inna allaha, like that, I say, what is this? You'll say, this is inna. And this is the ismu inna.
Ismu inna.
Ismu inna means it's its victim.
Okay.
It's the ism that got beat up by inna. And the short way of saying that is what? Ismu inna. The word Allah is? Ismu inna. So inna is the harf of nasab. You don't even have to call it a harf of nasab. You can just say inna. Mm-hmm. And then this will be, the word Allah became nasab, right?
Yeah.
So that'll be ismu inna. Just the word inna again, but what word before it?
Ismu.
Ismu inna, right? So if I say lakinna, is that one of them?
Yes.
Okay. So if I said lakinna allaha, you know what I'd say? This is lakinna, and this is ismu lakinna.
Ismu lakinna. Oh,
the first one was what? Ismu inna. This one's what? Ismu
lakinna.
Okay, so if I said la'allaha.
Isma la'alla.
This is la'alla?
La'alla.
You call it what it is. La'alla. And the word Allah would be what?
Isma
la'alla.
Ismu la'alla.
Oh, okay.
Ismu la'alla. Okay.
So you just apply ismu to whatever word is with it?
Right.
Okay.
So you say laytal muslima. So layta would just be called layta. And al-muslima would be called?
Ismu layta.
Excellent. Ismu layta.
It's pretty clever.
Yeah.
Whoever made that up.
Okay. Yeah, whoever made that up is pretty clever. So layta and ismu layta.
Yeah.
Inna wa ismu inna. Lakinna and ismu lakinna. Yeah. La'alla and ismu la'alla. Right?
Yeah.
So now you're actually learning how to describe these things in proper Arabic. So if I opened up a tafsir from like 500 years ago, and they were talking about an ayah that has inna, and then the word that became nasab, they'd call it inna wa ismu inna.
Oh, okay.
They'd actually use those words in there, right? So you're learning things that have been used for hundreds of years, right? Mm-hmm. And they also call it mudaf and
mudaf ilay.
They also call it jar and majrur. So now you're using the words and the descriptions that are being used for centuries by people from around the world that study the Quran, right? So yeah, it is pretty crazy and super cool. Okay, so I said that we have four properties of the ism.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And those four properties were status,
number,
gender,
and type.
And type. right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we did all that. Then, once you're done with the four properties of the ism, we have to study five fragments. And the fragment is more than a word, mm-hmm. less than a sentence. That's the definition of a fragment. And there are five of them. Mm-hmm. The first fragment is called the idafa, which is made up of a mudaf and a
mudaf
ilay. You already did it.
Yeah.
And you know how that works. The mudaf is the word before the of. Mudaf ilay is the word after the of. They have to be right next to each other. The mudaf is light, no alif lam. The mudaf ilay is jar. You know all of that and you've practiced it plenty. Yeah. Right? The second one is jar majrur. And majrur. And those are the words you memorized on page 27. Mm-hmm. How do they go? There was one of the students in the class, she commented, she's a mom and she homeschools her children. So she was having a hard time remembering ba ta ka flam wow, the first part.
Yeah.
So she said she rearranged it and made it into ba wow ka flam ta, and then made the word booklet.
She made
access a
wow.
So she just made the acronym booklet min fi an ala hatta ila.
Oh, that's
nice. whatever works.
Yeah. Okay. As long as you
gotta
memorize.
But I like batak aflabao too still. I'm, you know, old school. So jar majrur would be the second fragment, right? So what I'm saying is one way two words can come together is they could be mudaf and mudaf ilay. Yeah. Another way two words can come together is one of them could be a harf of jar and the other one get beat up by it.
Yeah.
The guy, the harf of jar is called the jar, and the guy that gets beat up will be called the majrur, right? Another way you can get something is inna and its ism, which could be lakinna and its ism, inna wa ismu, inna and ismu inna, lakinna and ismu lakinna, layta and ismu lakinna. We did that, right? So, and they just make the next word nasab. Now I want to add some things to this. This first one, mm-hmm. nothing comes between mudaf and mudaf ilay. This jar majrur, mm-hmm. nothing comes between a jar and a majrur. But inna and its ism, they are okay with a long distance relationship.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes they're right next to each other. Like, you know, when you read Surah Al-Asr, you read إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Right? So the words إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ, which one is the harf of nasab here? Tell me.
The harf of nasab, it's إِنَّ.
Good. And the thing that became nasab is what word here?
That became nasab is إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ.
Al-insana became nasab, right?
Yeah.
So this would be inna, and al-insana would be ismu inna.
Ismu inna.
The la here actually means truly. And then there's fi khusrin, and fi is one of the harf of what?
Jar.
Good. So fi would be the jar.
Jar, and then
and khusr would be the?
Majrur.
That's why it's khusrin, right?
Yeah.
So in this case, they were right next to each other.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
You guys memorized Surah An-Naba at all?
Amma
yatasa'alun?
Yeah,
like a
little bit.
Okay. Inna lilmuttaqina
mafaza.
Wow, well done. Mafazan. Let me tell you a little crazy story about inna lilmuttaqina mafazan. Inna is a harf of
jar.
Inna says, I really want to do one thing in my life. I want to make something nasab.
Wait, no, we said jar, isn't that?
Oh, nasab? Sorry, you're right. I messed up. Inna is a harf of nasab.
Yeah.
And Inna said, if there's one thing I want to accomplish in life, is make something nasab. I'm going to go on a quest to nasbify something. That is what I was made to do. So Inna goes over to Li. Yeah?
Yeah.
And Li says, excuse me, I'm a harf of jar. Haven't you heard of ba, ta, kaf,
lam?
Harf of jars don't have a status. Yeah. Harf of jars give a status to something else.
Oh.
Isms have status. Isms have rafa, nasab, and jar. Harfs don't have those properties. You can't make me jar. You can't make me nasab. I'm not even an ism. Get out of here. So it says, Inna says, I shall continue my quest and find someone to nasbalize. Right?
Yeah.
And he goes to the word al-muttaqina. Al-muttaqina ends with ina. And ina could be nasab or jar. So inna said, hey, you could be nasab or jar. Wanna nasab with me? Right? Yeah. And Lee says, excuse me, I'm a harf of jar. And I'm already jarifying
them.
Al-muttaqina.
Yeah.
So ina, this combination is actually jar, and nothing comes between a harf of jar and its victim, jar and majrur. Nothing comes between them. So not only could inna not have any effect on li, inna did not have any chance to have an effect on al-muttaqina, because li said, get out of here. Okay, we're together and you're not coming in between our friendship. Beat it. Inna says, fine, I'll just keep looking, I guess. And inna goes on and on and on until it finds what word?
Mafazan.
Is mafazan nasab?
No. Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. And you know why it's nasab?
Because
inna said, hey, I know you're far away from me. Do you want a nasab like over email? And mafazan says, fine. Yeah, I think it'll be successful. I said that because mafaz means success. But okay. And mafazan said, sure. Because inna means sure.
Oh, yeah. So they can be a long distance relationship.
That's right. Long distance relationship.
One's at college, one's at home.
That's right. Inna fi. Oh, maybe I should pull this ayah up. I wonder what ayah number it is. Let me. I'm.
From Jizama?
No, from Baqarah.
Baqarah?
Yeah, let me see if I'm totally not Dr. Zakir Naik.
Oh yeah.
He just
pulls it up in his brain. Like his brain is a Google.
Yeah.
Muslim Google. Especially Ahmed did that too. Ahmed did that was like a bomb.
Oh, sorry, messed up. لقومين.
One sixty-four.
Okay. So I'm gonna go to Baqarah. Here.
How long does it take somebody to like recite Baqarah like correctly?
Couple hours. Yes. 164. Here we go. What do you see in the beginning?
Inna.
Inna wants to make something what?
Nasabified.
So it came to fi.
Yeah.
So like, you want a nasab? He says, I don't do that. I'm a harf.
Oh, yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
I don't even have status. How are you going to make me nasab even if I don't even have status? Isms have status.
Yeah.
So Inna says, fine. I'll just go on to khalqi. And Fi says, no, you don't. Because Fi is a harf of what?
Jar.
And I don't allow anything to come between me and my majroor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't get to mess with me.
Yeah.
Khalqi is light and no al.
Yeah.
And as-samawati,
as-samawati
could be jar.
Yeah.
You remember atun, atin, atin?
Yeah.
So atin could be nasab or jar.
Yeah.
And the atin is ati here because the al doesn't like tanween.
Yeah.
Right? So this would make it, if it could be jar, it is jar.
Yeah.
So this becomes a mudaf and a
mudaf
ilay. So inna says, man, I'm out of luck. And then al-ardi is clearly jar,
yeah.
واختلافي الليلي والنهاري والفلكي إنّا says, man, I'm not getting any nasabs.
Yeah.
Right? And the ayah goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on until you get to this word.
Wow.
Read this word. The ayatin. Now, this is not, you remember when you did harf of jar, you said ba, ta, kaf,
lam.
This is not the same lam. That lam comes with an e sound, like alhamdulillah.
Yeah.
This lam is not with an e sound, it is with an
a
sound.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So it's not part of the harf of jar.
Yeah.
Okay? This is a neutral lam. We'll learn about this lam later. All you need to know right now is it is not a harf of
jar.
It's kind of like a floater. It doesn't really do anything.
Yeah,
it doesn't like nasbalize anything or jarify anything. It just kind of hangs out.
Okay. It's just a drift, I see.
It's a drifter, yes. Now, look at the word ayatin.
Ayatin.
Is that a sound or combination?
Combination.
Good. What combination is it?
Ayat.
Is it masculine or feminine?
Feminine.
Is it singular, pair, or plural?
This pair. Is pair.
Plural.
No, plural.
Plural.
Yeah.
And what status is it?
This is heavy.
It's heavy, but what status is it? Rafa or nasb or jar?
Oh, this is nasb or jar.
It's jar.
You're saying jar, you're saying nasb or jar. We have to figure this out. Muslimatun.
Muslimatin.
Muslimatin.
Oh, it's nasb or jar.
Right. Everything else was definitely jar.
Yeah.
The only thing that could be nasb or jar is ayatin in this ayah. And one day I will teach you how inna in the beginning of the ayah made ayatin nasb. Way down here.
Yeah. So, I gave you, seriously.
I only gave you this example, not because you're ready to understand the ayah yet, but to teach you one thing. There could be a pretty long distance between inna and its ism. Awesome.
Yeah.
There could be a long distance between them.
Yeah. But
or they could be right next to each other.
Yeah.
The issue is you have to know where did it beat, who did it beat up? And that's going to actually affect how we translate the ayah, right? So if the ayatin was right next to it right here,
mm-hmm.
me as someone trying to translate the ayah would translate it differently. But ayatin is way down there, so I'm going to have to translate it differently. And that's one of the skills we're going to learn when we understand this better. So I come back to what I was writing down for you. We did this. Okay, yeah. So we've done three fragments. We've done the mudaf and the mudaf ilay. We've done the jar and the majrur, and you've done inna and its ism, right? I said altogether, how many fragments are there going to be?
Five.
We're already done with three of them. We're already done with three, okay? What I'm going to try to do today, we have a couple of hours. I'm going to try to do four and five,
okay?
We're going to try to do four and five. Again, we're still one day behind as far as schedule is concerned, but I'm not too worried about rushing. I think comfortably we can do four and five today.
Okay.
So let's get started on number four. But before we do, I'd like to take any questions, Jawad, if people have them.
I think the biggest thing right now is, do you think we could do a couple more examples?
Of,
I think, each of these concepts.
Okay. Let's open up some Quran. That would be best. So let's open up Surah Al-An'am, my friend Dr. Suhaib's favorite surah, because he did a whole PhD on the surah. Okay. Lots of words here. We can't do all of them yet, but let's look at Wallahi. Wallahi. What do you think?
This is a sound.
No. How many words is it first?
Oh, it's two.
Mm-hmm. Are you familiar with the first word?
Yeah.
Bataka
flam wow.
Yep.
So
it's therefore, the word Allah is what?
Jar.
So what's the, how do you describe this?
Jar
and majrur.
Yeah.
Jar and majrur. Mushrikeena, just a word by itself. I just want four properties. I want status, number, gender, and type.
Ina is either jar or nasab.
Good, that's a good answer.
Okay, and then number,
mm-hmm.
it would come from a third. So
therefore,
it's plural.
Good.
So we've
got nasab or jar in plural. Good.
Yeah. And it doesn't have a sign to be feminine, so it's masculine.
Even a better, the answer is correct, but a better way to get that answer is it came from the masculine chart.
Oh yeah.
So it's masculine.
Yeah.
Right. What about common or proper?
It is.
Which
one is going to be? No, this is proper. No, this is common, yeah.
Why?
Why
is more important than the answer.
Because
if you see al on it,
it makes it
it's proper.
Proper. Oh, yeah. If you don't see al, it's common.
It's common. Okay. Let's see. Let's try this one. Akinatan. Four properties.
And it's nasab.
It would be
no.
Sound.
Yes,
no?
It's nasab, isn't it?
Yeah, it's sound.
It's nasab.
Sound, yeah.
Sound. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then.
It's singular.
Singular.
Yeah, or it could be a broken plural.
Yeah.
And then, so we got number. We need gender now.
Mm-hmm.
So the gender would be.
Look at it.
This would be, I think. Yeah, this would be feminine, right?
Why?
Because there's no sign of masculine.
Ah! No, wrong.
Because of the
no.
I forgot.
Oh, because of the 10.
Because of the hijab.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I forgot about the hijab.
That makes it a feminine.
Yeah.
So it's nasab. It's one. It's feminine. Is it common or proper?
This is. Because it's. This is common because it has no al.
Good. It's common because it has no al. Ooh. Now we get to the fun part. Kulla ayatin.
Kulla
ayatin.
This is jar.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Wait, no. How many words is this?
Two.
Okay. What do you notice about the first word?
Kulla.
Kulla.
So.
Right. But, you know, when you see. Let me ask you this. Or remind you of this. Normally, a word should be heavy. So the moment you see a word is light, you should start asking, why in the world are you
light?
And you know, one of the most common reasons, most popular reasons a word should be light is maybe it's a mudaf.
Yeah.
But light is just one part of being a mudaf. What are the two things that make a word
mudaf? It has no al.
Right. So you ask, hey, kulla, first of all, I'm going to suspect you because you're light.
Mm-hmm.
But let's see if you have an al on you.
He doesn't have an al.
Might be a mudaf.
Yeah.
How do you prove that 100%?
If the next word is ayah.
Ayah. Does it?
Yes.
Yeah. It does. Ayatin. Which means that this would be labeled what?
Mudaf.
You notice all the stuff I skipped?
Yeah.
Because you don't know yet. You will. Then more and more of this text will start getting read. And by day 10, most of it will be read. Like we'll be able to think about everything that's happening. Okay. Let's do this one. They're in two different lines. So I'll put them in one line. Asatiru al-awwalina. Asatiru al-awwalina. Okay. Is the first word suspicious?
Yes.
Why?
Because it is light.
Good. Because normally words should be?
Heavy.
Heavy. Good. So
and
it's light.
It doesn't have an L, so it could be a mudaf.
Good.
And then we have to check... Awalina.
Mm-hmm.
So, awalina.
Awalina, it's either nasab or jar.
But for this case, we would call it jar.
Yeah.
Very good, because the mudaf fits.
Yeah.
Asatir means legends.
Legends.
And awalin means the ancient people.
Ancient legends.
The legends of the ancient people.
Oh. You said it backwards.
Legends of, because you put it up between mudaf and mudaf, right? Legends of ancient people. Because some people said Quran is just legends of ancient people. It's just old stories. It's just myth. Okay, what about this one? I don't know if you can handle this. 3 more minutes, I'll give you your first break.
Okay.
Because I want to fry your brains after the break. Okay. So I'm going to give you a good, like, put your brains in the fridge for a little bit, let them cool off, and then I'll put them in the frying pan.
Okay, Allah, I already know this is a harf of jar.
Good.
So therefore, it's going to be jarified after that. So it becomes jar and majroor.
Excellent. Excellent. Al-Nar would be jar and majroor.
Yeah. I want to keep doing this. It's fun.
Okay. Do this one.
Man. But, okay. Man. This is a harf of nasab.
Is it? Man. What are the harf of nasab?
Inna, anna, ka, anna, bi, anna, layta, lakinna, la'alla, min.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? Min is in there, right?
Yeah. So there. Wait, no, it's not in there.
You just added it.
You guys so got trolled.
Yeah.
Woo.
So no, this isn't a harf of nasab. So about to have to move min fi an.
So which harf is it?
Min fi an.
Min.
Min fi an.
See, you looked at the sky and did it again.
Yeah. Min min fi an. Oh, it's a so it's a harf of jar.
Thank
it's
you.
A harf of jar. So okay, therefore, what's the next word? It gets jarified. So therefore, this is jar and majroor.
Is the next word jar because of an ending sound or an ending combination?
Combination.
Al-mu'minina.
Ina is because it's combination.
Yeah.
Excellent. Min al-mu'minina.
That's... Call me on that
one. I feel like you're trying to trick us somehow.
Uh-huh. Ooh, this one's crazy. But I'll tell you later. You can't handle that one yet. It's just,
you should try this.
It's gonna hurt your brain.
Can we get a harf of nasab example?
I'll ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. You asked, Allah gave.
ولكن
الظالمين بآيات الله يجحدون. We're gonna do all this.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. لكن. What kind of word is لكن؟
نصب.
Good. What should I do to the next word?
Become نصبفي.
It should نصبفي it. So الظالمين, which ends with an ending combination, could be نصب or جر.
Yeah.
But in this case,
it's
definitely نصب. How do I label this? How do I describe this sounding like an impressive
جار
Arabic exorber? No. How can you call this جار مجرور when it's not even a harf of جار?
Oh, sorry. اسم
This one will be called لكن.
Yeah.
And الظالمين would اسم لكن. Good job. This is لكن and this is اسم لكن.
Yeah.
That's how you label it. And this became نصب. Fine. Bi ayati Allahi. How many words do you see?
I see two.
No.
No, there's three.
There's three. How do you know there's three? Because you memorize them.
Yeah.
Ba ta kaflama. B, like Bismillah, a'udhu billah. The B will tell you that it is a harf of jar. Okay.
So therefore, the other word has to be jarified, so it becomes jar.
How many words do you see? I ask you again.
Three.
Okay. So let's deal with two at a time.
Okay.
So B would be the harf of jar.
Yes.
What is its victim? Who became jar?
Yati.
Ayati.
Oh, ayati. Yeah.
Ayati. Is ayati ending sound or ending combination?
Sound.
Astaghfirullah al-Azim. No.
No way. Oh, this is a combination.
Which one?
The feminine one.
Yes. Yeah. Why is there no E in on it?
Because there's no aleph or there's no lamb.
Because,
wait. Is it light?
Yeah, it's light.
Wait, it's light?
Yeah, it's light.
Yeah.
What else can I ask if it's light?
If it has an L.
Does it?
No. So this becomes...
This it might be light and no L because it's a...
Mudaf.
Which means the next word might be a...
Mudaf ilay.
How do I know if the next word is a mudaf ilay?
If it's jar.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh my God. This is... B was a jar.
Mm-hmm.
Ayati was the majrur.
Yeah.
Then ayati, because it's light and no alif lam, was the mudaf, and the word Allahi was the
mudaf
ilay. You guys are unlocking Arabic
wow.
of the Quran. You're unlocking it. You're starting We're to connect words together. B, jar, majrur, mudaf, mudaf ilay, lakinna, ismu lakinna, inna, ismu inna. Things are starting to connect. Remember I told you bricks start connecting to each other?
Yeah.
Now you're starting to connect them together.
We're picking like a million locks.
Yep. Now you're going to take a good 8-minute break and relax as much as you can. If you need to lie down and make, you know, snow butterflies without the snow, snow angels without the snow,
yeah.
Or if you need to roll around in the masjid, or you need to bang your head against the wall, or you want to use the punching bag in the gym, whatever you want to do, you do for 8 minutes. And right. You guys also just relax, stretch, get your blood circulating, because I'm going to fry your brains in 8 minutes. It's going to happen.
Deep fried. Okay?
Let's go.
Not just fried, deep fried, guys. Remember that.
Jawad, you're free to answer questions if students want.
There's a street of air.
Let me mute this mic so you guys can.
Okay, let's see. So I did see all of the questions about the wow before lakinna. Remember, the harf of jar, if we have a harf of jar, the ism has to come immediately after it. And there are different types of wow. So if you see a wow, and then after that there's no ism, then that means the wow we're looking at is not a harf of jar, and this waw is not a harf of jar. That's why we didn't pay attention to it. Sometimes you're going to see Ustad give examples from Quran, and he'll ignore parts of the ayah or parts of the word, and that's because it's something we haven't covered yet. And if you focus on the parts that Ustad is not focusing on, then more often than not, that's going to be something we haven't covered, and you're going to confuse yourself that way. So inshallah, make sure that when Ustad is giving examples and you see he's not giving attention to something, then it's better to let that go for now, and we'll come back to it, inshallah. Ayman maf'ul bihi is not the same as jar majrur. And try to keep, this is for everybody, try to keep your questions focused on the content that we're covering. Try not to go too far ahead. So if you guys go to the link at the bottom of the screen, the study resources link, you should see there are audio recordings underneath some of the videos. They should be available now. Let me double check. Yes, so underneath the day two video, you'll find the Muslim chart, and underneath the day four video, you'll find an overview of status. And then underneath yesterday, the day five video, you'll find the Harf of Jar and the Harf of Nasab recordings. Inshallah, those are free to view. Merciful Soldier, I did not understand your question. Please rephrase it or explain it a little bit, inshallah. Disa, you are correct. It's not only inna and it's ism, but it could be for any of the harf of nasab. So you can have lakinna and you can have the ism of lakinna. And you can have la'alla and the ism of la'alla and so on for all of them. And the long distance rule applies to all of them, or it can apply to all of them. Not that it will, but it can. Afshin, for kulla ayatin. Again, we haven't started looking at translations yet. So don't get too caught up on translations. One mistake you're making in your translation is you're flipping how we're supposed to translate it. You're bringing ayah first, and then of, and then whole. But it should be the other way around. Kulla comes first, so we translate that first. And kulla can mean all of something, or it can mean everything, right? So there are different ways we can translate it. Kulla ayatin could mean all of the sign. All of the sign. Isaac, harf jar and mudaf ilay are not the same thing. In a harf jar and its ism, we have the first word is a harf and the second word is an ism. So in that one, we have harf and then ism. Harf plus ism combination. But in an idafa, we have an ism and an ism combination. Both words in an idafa need to be an ism. But in jar majrur, one word is a harf, and one word is an ism. Same for harf of nasab. One word will be a harf, and then the victim of it will be an ism. So please do make that distinction. Merciful Soldier, fragments are groups of words. It's more than just one word, but it's not a full sentence yet. So when we look at, for example, وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ, this is two words, right? We have lakinna, one word, and then we have avalimina, that's two words. So it's more than a word, but it's not a whole sentence yet. We just have a part of a sentence. That's why we call them fragments. It's a fragment of a sentence. Ayman, I already answered that question. Okay. I am seeing a lot of requests to go over this last example, so we will, inshallah. Fahima, we have three different fragments going on. Unfortunately, I can't highlight different words or color them in on the screen, so you'll just have to follow along with my words, but we're going to go over everything that's highlighted red here. وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. So the first thing we have is we have a harf of nasab and its ism fragment. So لَكِنَّ was one of our harfs of nasab, right? We had inna, anna, ka'anna, bi'anna, layta, lakinna, lakinna. So here we have lakinna, harf of nasab. And then after that, we have a word that could be nasab. So it will be nasab, right? So we have harf of nasab, lakinna, and its ism is al-zalimina. Lakinna al-zalimina is our first fragment. Again, harf of nasab, lakinna, and its ism is al-zalimina. And then we move on to the next word, bi'ayati. And ba is one of our harfs of jar, right? Ba, ta, kaf, lam, waw. The first letter there, ba. Ba can be a harf of jar. And we see the word after it, ayati, is majroor. So we have to ask, why is ayati majroor? And the ba at the beginning of it, the ba attached to the beginning, is what's making it majroor. So here is our second fragment. Our first fragment again was لَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ. The second fragment is بِآيَاتِ. And this one is حَرْف of جَرْ بِ. And then its victim is آيَاتِ. Please do let me know if I need to explain any of that again, inshallah. And then the last fragment we have is آيَاتِ اللَّهِ. When we look at آيَاتِ, we see that آيَاتِ is light. And remember, we always need a reason to make something light. The default for a word is for it to be heavy. So when we see that a word is light, we need to ask ourselves, why is it light? And one of the main reasons we have for a word being light is if it is mudaf. And the two conditions for mudaf are light and no alif lam. So we see ayati, it's light. It also doesn't have alif lam. So it could be a mudaf. And the way we can confirm that is by looking at the word after it. The word after it should be jar as well. And the word Allah is jar. And that makes ayatillahi in idafa. So again, we have three fragments here. Walakinna al-zalimina is the first one, harf of nasab and its ism. Biayati is the second one, harf of jar and its victim. And then ayatillahi is the last one, and that's mudaf, mudaf ilay. I hope that was clear. Zahida, I already went over the waw of lakinna and why we didn't talk about that. That's not a harf of jar, that's a different waw. And we haven't learned that yet, and we'll learn it at some point, inshallah.
Come on, kiddos. Okay. It's time to start. Okay, let me talk to everybody. You guys can hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Jawad, can you hear me? Okay. Bismillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome back. I want to talk to you about a few things moving forward. What I'm going to teach you in the next hour is probably one of the, not probably, definitely one of the most important lessons of all of Arabic. People that become good at this become good at Arabic. People that are not good at this are not good at Arabic. It's a make it or break it. Okay, so it's one of those most important lessons of the Arabic language. I want to make sure you guys are very, very good at it. And, you know, there are still some questions that students have about the harf of jar and the harf of nasab. And, you know, just one thing I will say is that harf is a whole world. And unfortunately, just the way that the language is designed, harf share. So, for example, in Arabic, there's different kinds of wa. The letter wa. We said ba, ta, kaf, lam, wa, right? So the wa, there's different kinds. Only one of them is a member of the Harf of Jar gang. Mm, yes. But there are lots of other wows in the Quran that have nothing to do with the Harf of Jar. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you can ask, well, how am I going to know if it's a member or not? You will, when the time comes, as you become more and more advanced, you're going to know that it, you know, which one belongs to the Harf of Jar group and which one doesn't, right? Yeah. Same thing with Lam. There's like seven different kinds of Lam. So, you know, which one is the harf of jar and which one is not, you will know when the time comes. Right now, you just need to be introduced to one group at least. You can't know everything at once. You got to know one thing at a time and build up, right? So the lesson that I want to teach you, before I do that, I just need you to understand something about the way that I teach. Some things have to be memorized. So far, you've memorized three things. You memorized Muslimun, Musliman. Do this with me. Muslimun, Musliman, Muslimin, Muslimani, Muslimaini, Muslimaini, Muslimuna, Muslimina, Muslimina, Muslimatun, Muslimatan, Muslimatin, Muslimatani, Muslimataini, Muslimataini, Muslimatun, Muslimatin, Muslimatin. So you memorized that. That was page 6. You memorized the harf of jar on page 27. Those are ba, ta, kaf, lam, waw, min, fi, an, ala, hatta, ila. Excellent. Then you memorized the harf of nasab that are on page 28. Those are inna, anna, ka'anna, bi'anna, layta, lakinna, la'alla. Wonderful. Now you're going to memorize something on page 18. Okay, we're going a little bit backwards. Okay, so we did 6, 27, 28, and now we're going to head back on page 18. So I'd like you to open it up and let me explain it to you, and then we're going to discuss it.
What's like the title of the page?
Pronouns.
Oh, pronouns are crazy.
Ah, you do remember that.
Yes.
Good.
Oh, what's on the page?
What's that, the screen?
Oh, yeah. Time to show the screen. Okay, this is page 18. First word on page 18, you can see it on the screen here as you see it there, is the word huwa. Okay, the second word is what?
Huma.
Huma. And the third word is?
Home.
Home. Home, right? Then in the second line, you've got the word
hiya.
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 Hold on. We'll skip the grays. Hiya, then huma, and then hunna. Let me highlight it with my pen so you guys can follow along on the screen. Hunna. Then anta.
Anta.
Antuma.
Antuma.
Antum.
Antum.
Anti.
Anti.
Antuma.
Antuma.
Antunna.
Antunna.
Ana.
Ana.
Nahnu.
Ana. Nahnu.
Okay. These words are pronouns.
Yes.
Let me tell you something about the white boxes versus the gray boxes.
Mm-hmm.
The gray boxes we're not worried about right now at all. We almost pretend they don't exist right now. Okay. We don't care. We don't care. We don't care. We only care about the white boxes. Okay. The words you see in the white boxes are all rafa. I don't care how they sound. I don't care that they don't have a combination. I don't care that they don't have an ending sound because pronouns are crazy. They don't care about ending sounds. They don't care about ending combinations.
They're rebels.
They are rebels. Okay, so huwa, if somebody asked, what's the status of huwa? You'd say rafa. Huma, rafa. Hum, rafa. Hiya, rafa. Huma, rafa. Hunna, rafa. Anta, rafa. And if somebody says, anta is rafa? Are you crazy? Because anta looks like it's got an ah at the end. It should be nasab. No, it's a pronoun. You don't realize that it's crazy. It doesn't care about no sounds. Antuma, rafa. Antum, rafa. Anti, it's got an e. Should be jar. No, we don't care. It's a pronoun. Anti is rafa. Antuma rafa, antunna rafa, ana is rafa, and nahnu is rafa. Ana, ana, nahnu. All of these guys are rafa, and we don't care about their sound or their combination. So you notice in every single box is an RAF on top.
Yeah.
We should put an apostrophe there too, but rafa all the way through.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, you must know these pronouns and what they mean, all of them. Here's how we're going to learn that. You're going to repeat after me just these three. You're going to say huwa. Say it.
Huwa.
Huma.
Huma.
Hum.
Hum.
Huwa, huma, 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 hum.
Look at me and say it.
Huwa, huma, hum.
You say it.
Huwa, huma, hum.
Good. Huwa, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Look at it and say it. Huwa, huma, hum. No, not huwa, huma, huma. No, there's no huma, huma, huma.
Huwa, huma, hum. Hum. Hum.
Okay, this one has an M at the end.
Yeah.
This one has an N at the end. This is the only N.
Okay.
This one has an M in it. This one has an M in it. Okay? But the only N is this last one.
Okay.
So don't say huwa huma hun. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. So the only time the N shows up is right here at the end. Okay. Don't bring the N up before then, okay?
Okay.
Some students say huma huma hum, huma huma huna hunna 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 hunan chicken. Okay? No. Careful. Huwa huma hum. Say it.
Huwa huma hum.
You try?
Huwa hum, huwa huma hum.
Good. Hiya huma hunna.
Hiya huma hunna.
Try that second line 5 times. Hiya huma hunna. 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 One more. Hiya huma hunna. All 6. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. 5 more times. Look at it and say it out loud.
Huwa huma hum.
You can look at your page. It's clear in front of you. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. 3 more times. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Huwa not hiya. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. One more. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Okay, let's hear it.
Huwa huma
hun.
Hiya huma
huma. Oh, huwa.
Wow, you messed him up. Don't sabotage.
Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna.
That was excellent. I want to hear it again.
Huma no. Hiya huma
huwa.
Huwa huma huwa. Hiya huma.
I'm gonna make all kinds of faces. So huwa, you decide if my face is the validation for okay. Your answer.
Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hina.
Hey you here. Hey. Hunna.
Hunna.
Good. Again.
Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna.
Good. One more time.
Huma.
Nope.
No. Hiya huma hum.
No.
Huwa. 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 Hiya huma.
Relax. Breathe. Huwa
huma hum. Hum.
Hiya huma.
Hiya huma hunna.
Good. You get it right the first time, you mess up the second time. That's why I make you do it twice. You.
Huwa huma hun.
Nope.
Oh. What
Hum. All M's.
Oh, Fad, close your page. I can see it. Huwa huma. Huwa huma.
You don't have to say humma, you say huma.
Oh, hiya huma hun.
Hunna. Hunna.
Hunna.
So the only time you say like stressed. Well, the shadda is hunna. Everything else is easy going. Huwa huma hum. Repeat that.
Huwa huma hunna.
Don't wait. Repeat what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hun. Or
no N's.
Okay.
Only M's. Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hun.
Hum.
Oh, hum.
There's no end till the end.
Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hum.
Good. One more time. Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hum.
Good. Hiya huma hunna.
Hiya huma hunna.
Yes. Hunna. This has to be memorized. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Make noise and memorize it.
Okay.
All of you, make noise. This is time you have to take. Some of Arabic, I can only teach you if you know some things by heart. If you don't know them by heart, you cannot progress. So take some time out. Even if you didn't get to memorize it by the end of class today, before tomorrow, you got to put the time in. If it takes you 8 hours to do it, it takes you 8 hours to do it. Doesn't matter. You're going to do it. You have to, in your mind, get this bug out of your head. I can't do it. Get that out of your head. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna. Take 5 minutes and get this right. Go ahead.
Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hum.
Huwa huma hum. Hiya huma hunna.
I'm going to mute these guys so you guys don't get distracted by their struggle. You guys do your own struggle.
Let's see how productive those 5 minutes. Let's see how productive those 5 minutes were. Let's hear it, Mariam.
Hua Homa Hun. Hia Homa Hunna.
Hua Homa
Hunna.
Start over.
Hia Homa
Hunna. No, start over.
Oh,
from
okay,
the top.
Hua
Yeah.
Hua Homa Hum.
Good.
Hia Homa Hunna.
Excellent.
Hua Homa Hum. Hia Homa Hunna.
Good. Good. Hua means he.
Hua
means he. In every line, you memorize three words, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, remember this. First word you memorize is always one. Second word you in every line is always two. Third one is always more than two.
More than two.
Got it?
Yeah.
That'll make you remember the meanings easier, too.
Okay.
And so, hua, huma, hum is three words.
Yeah.
Hua will be one. Huma will be two. Hum will be plural. Hia, huma, hunna. Which one is one?
Hia.
Good. Which one is two?
Huma.
Which one is more than two?
Hunna.
Okay, now listen to the meanings. Hua is he. How many people is he?
One.
Huma, both of them. What does it mean, both of them? How many?
Two.
Hum means they.
A lot of people.
A lot of people. Yeah. Hia means she. How many people is that?
One.
No.
Oh, one. I'll think of
unless she has multiple personality disorder, it's still one person. Okay? Hia is one person. Huma
is
both
two.
Of those women.
Yes, two.
Okay, both of them. And you know the word for both of those men and both of those women, or man and woman, doesn't matter. Huma is the same word.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then hunna is the feminine version of they. Okay. Now, in English, we don't have that. If there's a group of women, I say they.
Mm-hmm.
If there's a group of men, I say they. And if I see a group of men and women, I still say
they.
But the Arabs have a they for men. Or men plus women, they have that, which is hum, right? And then they have a they, which is just for women,
yeah.
Right? And that's hunna.
Hunna.
So I like to translate that in Texan as them ladies.
Oh, yeah. I remember this.
Okay? Hunna. Because we don't really have a word for that in English. So them ladies. Okay. So what does hua mean without looking?
Hua he.
Hua he.
Good. Huma.
Both of them.
Good. Hum.
They.
Hia.
She.
Huma.
Both of them.
Hunna.
They.
They what?
Them ladies.
Them ladies.
Can you say all six of them with their meanings to me?
Hua he. Huma. Both of them. Hum. They.
Good.
Hia, she.
Good.
Huma, both of them. And then hunna, them ladies.
Brilliant. Excellent job, Mariam.
Okay, who is he? Huma is they. And then...
No, Huma is not they.
Who are Huma? Huma is they, right? No, Huma is both of them.
Good. Second one's always going to be two people. Yeah. Good.
Third one is who are Huma, hum. Hum is they.
Good.
He is she.
Good.
Huma.
Hia Huma.
Hia Huma, that's both of them.
Good.
And then Hunna is them ladies.
Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. And what status are all of them?
Rafa.
Always Rafa.
Yeah.
Always Rafa. Okay. Now.
Does pronouns just have like a fetish for Rafa?
No, I don't like that word. Anta. And you'll see the nasab and jar pronouns too. Anta.
Anta.
You. Anta means what?
You.
You.
Oh.
Take a guess. Antuma. What do you think it means?
They.
The second word's always how many?
They.
Don't look at the meaning.
Oh, both of you.
Both of you.
Yeah.
If anta means
you,
antuma means
both of you.
And the third word is antum. What do you think it means?
They.
No. We already did they. They is.
Oh.
You.
You all.
You all. What?
Or because we're in Texas, y'all.
Y'all.
Okay.
Oh, you all. Okay.
Antum is y'all, yeah. All of you.
Yeah.
Okay. So anta means what? You.
You.
Antuma.
Both of you.
Both of you. Antum.
You.
All of you. Now, remind yourself of something.
When you did huwa huma hum, right?
Mm-hmm.
The meaning was he, both of them, and they, right? Remember?
Yeah.
He's not here. Mm-hmm. Both of them are not here. And they are not here. They're far away. She isn't here. Both of them aren't here. They are, those women aren't here. They're far away. But anta, you're here.
Yeah.
And once you start with any word that starts with ant, the meaning has to have you in it.
Yeah.
Okay. So anta is you. Antuma is both of
you
because it has ant in it. Yeah. This ant part, you definitely have to translate this with a you. Okay. And then antum means all of
you.
You cannot use the word they here. Why not? Because the word they doesn't have what in it? It doesn't have you in it.
Yeah.
But the moment you have ant being used,
it has a you.
It has to have a you.
Okay.
What happens in our head is when we see antum is many, the first word that comes in our head is they. That's millions of students make the same mistake. They think of antum and they think of they. But you have to get used to antum meaning
y'all.
Yeehaw. Okay. Anta, you. Antuma, both of you. Antum,
y'all.
Anti.
Anti.
That's the girl version of you. Mariam, if I was talking to you, I wouldn't say anta. That would be offensive. I would say
anti.
And if I was talking to Ahmed, I would use anta. Okay, so anta is for a male and auntie is for a female. The way I used to remember that is auntie is a female, so auntie.
Yeah.
So I'm calling you an auntie when I say auntie Mariam. Auntie Mariam. I meant auntie Mariam. Okay,
right.
You are Mariam. So auntie is the you, but we don't have a girl version of you in
English.
In English, right? So some of my students came up with Yushi.
Oh, yeah, I remember Yushi.
Yushi. Or some others came up with Shiyu.
Shiyu.
But none of those are actual English. But if you say, I traveled in so many different communities. I taught this basic level of Arabic maybe 200 times.
Wow.
Okay. And literally more than maybe almost 100,000 people, like all over the world, right? Different places in the world. And sometimes the crowd, I have two of you in front of me now. Sometimes when I was teaching this class, there was like 500 people in front of me or 1,000 people in front of me. Or, you know, it was crazy, right? Or 100 people, in small groups, even 80 people. But someone, and I, whenever I asked, what does anti mean? Someone always said Yushi. I didn't say it. Somebody in the crowd came up with it. Somewhere in the ummah. So I gave up and I said, you know what? All over the Muslim world, in our head somewhere, Yushi exists.
Yushi.
So I accepted Yushi as a translation because it seemed to be ijma' of the ummah on Yushi.
So you it's, never knew who it was?
It was always somebody. Someone always came up with Yushi.
Like okay. All over?
Yeah. I was like, okay, fine. I'll eat some sushi and I'll accept Yushi. It's okay. All right. So anti is the feminine you or Yushi.
Yeah.
Antuma. Both of you.
Both of you.
Antum or Antunna, the last one. Antunna. Notice Antunna is kind of like Hunna. Remember that gave us a hard time?
Mm-hmm.
Hunna is them ladies.
Mm-hmm.
And Antunna is y'all ladies.
Y'all ladies.
So whenever you see the double N at the end, the Unna, that's for ladies.
Okay.
So the difference between Hunna above and Antunna below is that Hunna above was for them ladies. And antunna at the bottom is for y'all ladies. Now, the ones you memorized were huwa, huma, hum, hiya, huma, hunna. Now you're going to do anta, antuma, antum. Say it.
Anta, antuma, antum.
Good. Not that hard. Anta, antuma, antum.
Yes. Anta, antuma, antum.
Anta, antuma, antum.
Anta, antuma, antum.
Anti, antuma, antunna.
Anti, antuma, antina.
Good. Anta, antuma, antum.
Anti, antuma, antum.
Anti, antuma, antunna.
Anti, antuma, antunna.
Guys that are, folks that are watching this online, all of you have to say this out loud with me for this to sink into your own minds. If you're passively listening, it's not going to be remembered. You have to make noise.
Anti,
You have to, and I can't get gauge that from you. So you have to do this. And of course, if you memorized it, send me videos. Arabic@bayina.com. I'd love to see it. Okay. Anta, antuma, antum.
Antum, antuma, antuma, antum.
Anti, antuma, antunna.
Anti, antuma, antunna.
Let's try to say this. You can look at it and say it five times with me. Okay. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna. 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 One more. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna. So I would like for you to volunteer to me. Huwa huma hum hiya huma hunna anta antuma antum anti antuma antunna.
Oh, this is what you were saying this yesterday, right?
I was not.
Oh, goodness. He says a lot of stuff.
I say a lot of stuff.
Okay. Huwa huma hum.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, let me help you.
That helps out a lot. Yep. Thank you. Huwa huma hum hiya huma hunna. Antum antuma.
Oh, anta.
Anta antuma.
Start over. When you make a mistake, you start over.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, antum antuma antum,
anta,
anta antuma antum.
Start over, you messed up.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, antum ant.
Nope, not antum, anta.
Anta antuma antum.
Start over.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti Tuma.
Yes.
And tunna.
Yes, too slow. Start over. It was perfect though.
Okay. Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti antuma antunna.
Yeah, why is the car slowing down at the end? It's pulling up in a driveway?
Yeah.
Anti antuma antunna. Go, one more time. You got it.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti antuma Antunna.
You said antunna twice. Again. I did perfect.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anto, anta antuma antum.
Maybe the antu anta. No. Flawless victory. I need flawless. I need flawless.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti antuma antunna.
That's it. Wow.
Took me so many tries.
That was good. That was solid.
Huwa huma hum.
I heard that. Hu. Nope. Start over.
Huwa huma hum.
I don't want to hear hum. I want to hear hum. So start over.
Huwa huma hum.
Yes.
Here. Is it here?
Mm-hmm.
Huwa huma hunna.
Yep. Now you know you're going to start over. That's okay.
Okay. How to start again?
Huwa.
Oh, huwa huma hun.
Hum.
Huwa huma hum.
You sound angry.
Huwa huma hum. Huwa huma hum.
Yeah.
Hiya huma hunna.
Mm-hmm.
Anta antuma antum. Anti antu anti anti antuma anti antuma
antunna.
Antunna.
Okay.
From the beginning.
Oh, you know. Yes. You already know.
Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna.
Yeah, that was too much hesitation, so start over.
Huwa huma hun.
Hun is not ord. I think that was in Mulan or something, the Huns.
Hiya huma hum.
No, we didn't start with hiya.
Oh. Huwa. Huwa huma hum.
Yes.
Hiya huma hunna.
Yes.
Anta antuma antum.
Yes.
Anti antuma antunna.
Epic. Great job. Great job. Fantastic. We missed it. Yeah, totally missed it. Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti antuma antunna. And the last two words are ana nahnu. Say those words.
Ana nahnu.
I will make you memorize that. I expect you to remember it easily. Ana nahnu, okay? All the words you just memorized are what status?
Rafa.
Okay. Huwa means he. Huma means, remember, you say three words at a time.
Yeah.
First one's always one person. Second one's always two people. Third one's always more than two people. Yeah. Right? So huwa means he. Now you can guess the meanings. You don't have to memorize them because one, two, three, right?
Yeah.
Huwa means he. Huma means both of them. Hum means they. Hiya means she. Huma means both of them. Hunna means them ladies because it was one she that became them ladies, right?
Yeah.
Anta means you. Antuma means both of you. Antum means all of y'all. Anti means Yushimitsu. Antuma means both of you. And Antunna means y'all ladies. Y'all ladies. Ana means I. And Nahnu means we. Nahnu means we. Okay. Those are your pronouns. And they are always what status?
Rafa.
They're always Rafa status. One last time so I can feel better about myself. You're going to say them out loud with me. Keep up with me. Hua, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, anta. Start over. Hua, huma, hum. Hiya. Start over. Hua, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna. Ana, nahnu.
I,
nahnu.
Nahnu.
Ana, nahnu.
Ana, nahnu.
Right. Ana is I and nahnu is
we.
Again, the status of all of them is what?
He.
Rafa.
The status, status of all of them is Rafa. How many properties does this nism have?
Four.
Two of them are always the same.
Yeah.
For these guys, status is always Rafa and the type is always proper.
Okay.
Okay. So the only two other properties left are what? Number two, and?
Type.
No, number and gender.
No, gender.
Because type is always what?
Common.
A proper.
Top type is always proper. Status is always rafa. So when you're reading in the Quran, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Right? You hear the word huwa?
Yeah.
Rafa. What's the type? Proper. Because pronouns are always proper.
Yeah.
In your notes, I made you made a list of seven things that are proper.
Yeah.
One of those things was actually pronouns. Okay. These guys. Any one of them, if you see them, automatically the answer is proper. Okay, so two things are permanent. They're always rafa and they're always proper. Okay, now these words, they are broken up the way you, I want you to think about them. I don't just want you to memorize these words. I want you to think about them. I made you memorize them three at a time, right? Why three at a time? The first ones are always, the first one's always one, the second one's always two, and the third one's always
three.
And so if you know the meaning of the first one, then double that meaning and then triple that meaning. So if it's he, then he times two is two guys, so both of them, and he times many is many people, which means they. Then it's she, hia, both of those women, and then them women, them ladies.
Yeah.
Then it's, if it's you, anta, then it's both of, antum is both of you, and then antum is all of you. And anti is the feminine you, antuma is the feminine both of you, both you women, and antunna is you women, plural. And then ana nahnu is I and we, easy, right? And the we can be used for one person, two people or more people.
So right? If you see like hunna, you're always just gonna know, that's rafa.
That's rafa. Easy.
Okay.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay. Hunna is rafa, and it's proper. Okay.
So they just gotta find the two gender and.
Let's talk about that. Well, if I ask you about hua, how many people is that?
Hua, that's one.
So you already know the number.
Okay.
And hua, is that a guy or a girl?
He.
That's he.
That's he. Masculine.
So, it's masculine.
So you already know the gender. Actually, automatically, you know all four properties every time.
Wow.
You don't even have to like analyze nothing. If you because you know the meaning, you already know all four properties. Mm-hmm. Two of them are permanent.
Yeah.
And the other two are common sense. So, like, for example, anta, right?
Yeah.
So, it's rafa because they're all rafa.
Yeah.
It's proper because they're all proper. It's singular because it's one you.
Yeah.
And it's for a guy because the girl version is anti, so it's masculine. Done. All four properties. Status, number, gender, and type. So straightforward.
Like, yeah. So, if like, I see somebody, I'll be like I see a guy, anta, come here. Can I say that?
Yeah, you can.
Okay, I'm going to say that's my like brother.
Okay. Hey. Ya ant.
Ya
anta.
Ya anta.
You can do that. You can do that in Arabic. Okay.
Slowly but surely.
Okay. Now, what version are they always? What status are they?
Rafa.
Good. But there is such a thing as nasab and jar too, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, there is.
There is.
I mean, in Arabic.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, in Arabic there is. Yeah.
So what they did was they decided that these words, these rafa ones, we call them independent pronouns.
Independent.
That's their name. That's their official name for this class. What are they called?
Independent pronouns.
You'll understand why they're called independent pronouns in a sec, but independent pronouns are always rafa, right? Now, the independent pronouns are written independently. They're written by themselves. Mm-hmm. Each one of them has a cut.
We can't see the screen.
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. So each one of these independent pronouns has a cousin.
Yeah.
That cousin is not an independent version. That's called an attached version. What version?
Attached.
Okay. When you see the independent version, which is what you memorized, mm-hmm. they're all rafa. When you see the cousin, mm-hmm. the attached version, that can only be nasab or
jar.
That's what they're for.
Okay.
So the independent ones are for rafa and the attached ones are for nasab or jar. A question that the student that represents the entire ummah will ask, how am I supposed to know when it's rough, nasab, or jar? Relax.
Calm down.
Just take a breath, ummah, and just breathe. We will learn this in time. Okay? But right now, I want you to know that each one of them has a cousin. Hua has a cousin. Huma has a cousin. Huma has a cousin. Hiya, Huma, Huna. And you got to know each one's cousin. Okay? So let me introduce you to these cousins. Hua, his attached version is who. Let me change the font so it looks a little nicer. Much better. Hua, the cousin is what?
Who.
If you, and Hua, I called it attached, right?
Yeah.
You know what that means? It comes at the end of a word.
Oh, okay.
It's not written, it's never written by itself. So for example, we say, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa
Rasuluhu.
Okay? That who at the end,
mm-hmm. yeah.
that's an attached version of Hua. Okay?
Yeah.
If you see who, that can only be what status?
Nasab or jar.
Do we care about the ending sound anymore?
No.
Because if we went by ending sound, we would say that it's rafa.
Yeah.
We don't care. Mm-hmm. Pronouns don't care.
Okay.
They only care about two things. Are you independent or are you attached? If you were independent, mm-hmm. I would say that you're rafa. If you were attached, I would say that you can only be nasab or jar. Good. Now,
so like
who's Hua's cousin?
Who.
Who. What was the next word after Hua?
Huma.
Huma has an identical cousin, Huma. So you don't even have to learn something new.
Okay.
Hum has an identical cousin.
Hum.
You don't have to learn anything new. The only new cousin you had to learn was Hua becomes what?
Who.
Who. Okay. Now, Hia has a cousin who laughs a lot. Ha. She's funny. Ha. Okay. He has a funny cousin.
Yeah.
Okay. Hua has a confused cousin. He's always asking, who?
Who?
Okay.
Okay.
And Hia has a funny cousin.
Ha.
Ha. Okay. And then Huma, identical cousin.
Mm-hmm.
Huma. And Hunna, identical cousin.
Hunna.
Hunna. Did you have to learn much?
No.
Okay, let me ask you. I'll say the original version. You'll say the attached version.
Okay.
Hua.
Who?
Huma.
Hum.
Hum. Hia.
Ha.
Ha.
Remember she's funny?
Yeah.
Ha.
Ha.
Huma. Huma.
Huma.
Hunna.
Hunna.
You know all the cousins. You know the first six cousins. Now let me show you the next six cousins. They're super easy. Anta.
Anta.
Anta ends with ta, right?
Yeah.
So the thing is, the Arabs decided that the cousin should rhyme with ta, except should be with the letter K. So instead of ta, they made it into what?
Ka.
Ka. So the way anta ends, anta becomes ka. Now check this out. Antuma, right? Ends with tuma. So they just said keep tuma, but just make it with a K, kuma. So antuma is
kuma.
So just hear the end and repeat it with a K. So anta becomes ka. Because you heard the ta.
Yeah.
So anta becomes
koma.
No, listen to what I'm saying. Listen. Don't look. Listen now. Anta
becomes ka.
Becomes ka. It's about your ear. Antuma becomes
koma.
Kuma. Just rhyme it. Antum becomes
an.
You don't need the an anymore.
Kum.
Just kum.
Kum.
Let's start over. Anta
becomes ka.
Becomes ka. Antuma
becomes
kuma. Antum
becomes
kum, and t becomes
kanti,
and t, you don't need the an anymore.
Kanti,
you're making it too hard on yourself.
What did you do with anta?
Anta
became.
Ke.
So anti should become.
Ki.
Oh, that's it.
Ki. Oh,
okay. Super easy.
Yeah.
Let's start over. Anta becomes.
Ke.
Good. Don't need the screen. Just your ears. Right now, you just need the ears. Anta becomes.
Ke.
Ka. Antuma becomes.
Koma.
Koma. Antum becomes.
Kum.
Kum. Anti becomes.
Ki.
Good. Antuma becomes.
Come.
Listen carefully. Antuma becomes.
Come.
That's it. Antunna becomes.
Come.
Kunna.
Kunna.
Tunna became kunna, right? So yeah. Antunna became.
Kunna.
Kunna. Okay, let's start over. Hua becomes.
Hua becomes. Who?
Yep. Hua becomes his cousin. Who? Huma.
Hum. Hua.
Okay. Identical cousins.
Yeah.
Huma.
Hum.
Okay, my fault. Hua becomes
who?
Who? Huma becomes
Huma.
Hum becomes
Hum.
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 Hum becomes Hum. Stays the same. Hia becomes
he.
Oh, ha.
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 Yeah.
Huma becomes
Huma.
Good. Huma. Hunna.
Hunna.
Stays Hunna. Anta
becomes Ka.
Good. Antuma.
Koma.
Koma.
Antum.
Antum.
Kum. Not ankum.
Kum.
Just kum.
Yeah,
anti.
Ki.
Good. Ki. Antuma.
Antuma.
Koma.
Koma. Antunna.
Koma.
Kunna.
Antunna.
Kunna.
Good. Good. So you memorized hua huma hum. Hia huma hunna. Anta antuma antum. Anti antuma antunna. Ana nahnu. Then hua becomes who? Huma huma hum hum hiya ha huma huma hunna hunna antaka antumakuma antumkum antiki antumakuma antunna kunna anani or inahuna. The last two I didn't tell you. Ana becomes ni or e. Say that for me.
Ni or e.
So you get two of those.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So ana, you get ni or e. Okay? Ni or e. And nahnu becomes na. Nahnu becomes what?
Na.
Okay, let's do this oral exercise again. Okay? I'll keep nahnu on the screen. I will say the original. You will say the attached.
Okay?
Okay? We'll switch. We'll take turns. So one for you, Ahmed, and one for you, Maryam.
Okay?
Hua.
Who?
Huma.
Huma.
Hum.
Hum.
Hiya.
Ha.
Huma.
Huma.
Hunna.
Hunna.
Anta.
Anta. Anta. Ka.
Antuma.
Kunna or kuma.
Listen carefully. Antuma.
Kuma.
Good. Antum.
Antum. Kum.
Good. Anti.
Anti. That become ki.
Good. Antuma.
Kuma.
Antunna.
Kunna.
Yes. Anna. That was a new one.
Anna.
You got two of them.
Yeah or ni.
Near E, we'll just say near E. Nahnu. Excellent. Those are the attached versions.
Okay.
What's the difference between the independent version and the attached version? The independent versions are always what status? And the attached versions are always what status? Okay, I'm going to tell you the ridiculous joke that I will never get tired of. It's not really a joke, it's a true story.
True story?
Yeah, true story. I had an uncle in Pakistan who called me and said, Ya Numan, you watch so many American movies, right? I was like, not really. He goes, but there's one actor I can't find picture anywhere. He wanted a picture of an American actor.
Okay.
I was like, just, okay, fine. Tell me his name. He said, Thind. Like, what? His name is Thind. I was like, yeah. And he said, I'll send you the spelling. He can't find this actor. He's in every movie. Thind.
Thind.
What do you think he's talking about?
The end.
The end.
The end.
Because, you know, at the end of the movie, it says the end.
Yeah.
He's like, I can't find Teen anywhere. What was his problem? He thought this was what?
An actor.
Mm-mm. Bigger than that. He thought this was one word.
One word. Oh.
It was two words, isn't
it? Yeah, the end.
Okay, well, here's why I told you this ridiculous story. You see that? Looks like one word.
Yeah, but it's two.
It's actually two words. And now you know that there's something called attached pronouns and you memorize them. Mm-hmm. And now your job is going to become to recognize them. Okay. Now, I said the original mm-hmm. and you gave me the attached. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go backwards. I'll say the cousin and you'll give me the original.
Okay.
Who?
Hum.
Nope.
Who?
Who
hum. Is?
Huma.
No, it's not Huma.
It's who?
Who is it?
Hua.
Hua.
Who, the cousin,
yeah.
is originally?
Hua.
Hua. Huma?
Huma.
Hum?
Huma.
Hum?
Hum.
Hum. Ha?
Ha.
What is that one? The female one. What is it called?
Hia.
That's it.
Yeah.
Ha is actually, the original is what?
Hia.
Mm-hmm. Huma?
Huma.
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 Hunna?
Hunna.
Ka?
Cow.
Key,
or no.
No, ka. It's, it'll rhyme with ka. The ka. End of it will rhyme with ka.
What was it called? It was
anta.
Good.
Anta. Okay,
yeah. Ka will become
anta.
Anta. It came from antaka. Yeah. So it's basically you take the ka and replace it with the letter T and say it again.
Okay.
So if I say, where did ka come from? You say to yourself, ka, which means ta. Oh, anta. Kuma.
Antuma.
Good. You got the idea.
Yeah.
Antuma. Kum.
Antum.
Antum. Antum. Ki.
Ki.
Anti.
Anti.
Oh,
Kuma.
Kum.
Antuma.
Kuma.
Antuma.
Antuma.
Yeah.
Kunna.
Antunna.
Antunna.
Ni or E?
Ni or E. Na.
Anna.
Anna.
Na.
Nahnu.
Nahnu. In other words, I need you to be able to go backwards and forwards.
Okay.
You got to memorize page 18?
Yeah.
You got to know the meaning of every word on page 18?
Yeah.
You got to know the originals of page 18? You got to know the attached versions of page 18? And you got to know them backwards and forwards. So if I give you a cousin, you can tell me the original. If I give you the original, you can tell me the cousin.
Okay.
Okay. Now let me show you something. Pick a surah. Pick a longer surah.
Abasa.
Okay, Abasa.
Oh, yeah. Abasa.
This is Surah Abasa. No, there was an error. It didn't give me the whole surah. I got to report that to the developers.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Abasa wa
tawalla an ja'a.
Oh.
Ooh.
It's like,
ooh. Who's that cousin's with?
Huwa.
That's right.
Yeah.
Al-a'ma. Wa ma yudri.
Ka.
Ka. Who's that cousin's with?
Anta.
Anta. La'alla. Who
Hua.
Comes from?
Hua.
Hua. أو يذكر فتنفع. Who comes from? Hua. أما من استغنى فأنت. Did you do this word?
أنت.
أنت is the original, isn't it?
Yeah.
What does أنت mean?
أنت she.
That's
no.
هي.
أنت.
أنت both of them.
Nah.
They.
I can't remember.
Y'all.
أنت means. You.
Oh, you.
Antuma
oh.
means both of you. Antum means all of you. You know what that means? You've got to do review with homework and really get the meanings of the pronouns down and the memorization of them down. I can start you off, but you're going to make it solid on your own, okay? Anta means you. But you, it is one of those you memorize, right?
Yeah.
Who.
It's who.
La who. Yeah. The who and la who. Where does that come from?
Hua.
Hua. Wa ma alay. Ka comes from where?
Anta.
Wa amma man jaa ka.
Anta.
Anta yas'a wa huwa wa huwa. Is that familiar?
Yeah.
That's
the proper.
Yes, he. Huwa yakhsha. Fa anta.
Fa anta. Oh yeah, that's.
Oh yeah.
That's you.
You, very good. Anta antum antum. You, both of you, all of you. An who?
An who? That's like huwa.
That's right. It's the attached version. Kalla inna ha. Ooh, ha? Ha? I've never heard of ha before ever in my life.
Ha.
Have I?
Ha.
Ha. Funny. Huh. That's funny.
Here.
Good. Here. فَمَنْ شَاءَ ذَكَرَهُ
That's
هو. فِي صُحُفٍ مُكَرَّمَةٍ مَرْفُوعَةٍ مُطَهَّرَةٍ بِأَيْدِي سَفَرَةٍ كِرَامٍ بَرَرَةٍ قُتِلَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا أَكْفَرَهُ هو من أي شيء خلقه هو من نطفة خلقه
هو
فقدره
هو
ثم السبيل يسر هو ثم أمات هو فأقبر
هو
ثم إذا شاء أنشر هو كلا لما يقض ما أمر
هو So many
who's. Yeah. Let's see. فَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا
That's like,
ها.
ها. Oh, here.
وَزَيْتُونًا وَنَخْلًا وَحَدَائِقَ غُلْبًا وَفَاكِهَةً وَأَبًّا مَتَاعًا لَكُمْ
لَكُمْ
كُمْ
or like
أنتم.
أنتم.
If أنت means you, and antuma means
both
of you, and antum
means
na
all of you.
That's the cousin of all of you. Kum antum kum, right? Wali an'ami
kum
antum. فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةُ يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ Okay, so we'll deal with this subject now before I take questions from you, Jawad, okay? You see how many?
Yeah.
That's crazy, right?
Yeah, it's like a lot of it.
Yep. Short surah. Surah Al-Kawthar, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's see if you find any pronouns in Surah Al-Kawthar at all.
Kata's three ayahs. There's like three ayahs. And like, there's only three surahs with three ayahs, but like, there's only like one that's like very short. It's the surah.
Okay. In na.
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 Is that a pronoun?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the
Ana.
Ana.
Ana is near E.
Oh,
near.
It's the
Ana.
Last one. An. Nahnu.
Oh, nahnu.
Becomes
na.
Na. Inna a'tayna.
Ka.
Ka.
That's
here,
or
Hua. It's not Hua, no.
Oh, it's Hua, not
Hua. Hua becomes who?
Antuma.
Antuma would be Kuma.
Oh,
it's got a rhyme.
Antum.
Antum would be Kum, because it would rhyme with Antum.
Anta.
Anta would be Ka. You see it?
Yeah.
Okay. Fasalli li Rabbi
Ka.
Ka, which would come from?
Anta.
Anta. Wanhar inna shani'a.
Ka.
Ka.
Hua. That is.
That's the original one. That's the independent one.
Yeah.
So the bunch of attached ones, and there's an original one, right? If they are attached, the status can only be
nasab
or jar. If they are independent, the status is always
rafa.
Okay. So hua. Let's do this together. Hua, huma, hum. Hiya, huma, hunna. Anta, antuma, antum. Anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. Ana, nahnu. Very good. Okay. So, inna a'taynaka al-kawthar, fasalli rabbika wanhar inna shani'aka hu al-abtar. I'll take questions before I do the he concept. Jawad, if there's a he question, then skip it. Otherwise, tell me.
How can we tell the gender for ana and nahnu?
You can't. Context. If Allah is talking about somebody, if Maryam is speaking and she says ana, then you're not going to be confused. So the context will tell you. You don't have to worry about the gender. The story, which story is it, will determine. Okay?
Yeah. So hum and antum can be used for men and women. Can
yes.
Hua and anta also be used like that?
Hua and anta are singular. So you can't make one person a man and a woman at the same time. So hua and anta can only be used for males. But the plurals... maybe they're referring to the pairs and they said it wrong. The pairs could be a man and a woman. Like antuma could be one man and one woman. Allah uses antuma for Adam and Hawa, for example. And he also uses it for two men, like Musa and Harun. And huma is used for the two wives of the prophets Nuh and Lut. So huma can be used for a man and a woman, huma can be used for two men or two women, like that. But the singulars are clear. Other questions?
Yes. In the word inna, there's a lot of confusion because inna is supposed to be harf nasab, so how can that also be a pronoun?
So inna is a pronoun, right? And what's its job? Its job is to make the next word
nasab. Yeah.
And nahnu is the original pronoun, which means we. But you cannot use nahnu with inna because nahnu is what status? All the original pronouns are rafa status. Inna cannot accept something rafa. Yeah. Inna has to take something nasab. So what's the nasab version of nahnu?
Nahna.
No, nahnu becomes na. Nahnu becomes
na.
And we call it the attached version because it literally gets attached. So it becomes what? Innana. Innana. That's how you say certainly we. Okay. Now, the Arabs said innana so many times that they made it acceptable to say the two ends together and just make it inna. So inna is just a short way of saying innana. And in the Quran, you find innana and you also find inna. Both of them are okay to say. Because that's where the inna and inna a'tayna kal-kawthar comes from. It's not one word. If it was just half of nasab, it would just be inna. Where is the alif coming from? The alif came from na, which is from nahnu. And the only reason that was used is nahnu you can't use with inna. Yeah. The same way, if you wanted to say inna and anta together, right? Yeah. You can't, because anta is the rafa version. Mm-hmm. Inna can only accept the nasab version. Nasab, yeah. What's the nasab or nasab version of anta? Means the attached version. What's the attached version of anta?
Ka.
Good. Ka. And because it's called the attached version, because it literally gets attached.
Innaka.
That's why you read innaka in the Quran. Okay. Mm-hmm. Other questions?
Yeah. The last one is for the word fa'anta. How can anta be attached?
Okay. Fa'anta. There are some words in Arabic like fa and la, and you know, there's a very small group that basically have no grammatical effect. They are neutral, they can float on anything and sit on anything, and fa is one of those words. So fa can just be there and have no impact grammatically and force the word to change. It's still considered independent. Okay, so some letters are like that, and you'll obviously, what you're learning at this level doesn't answer all the questions about the text of the Quran. The Quran's text is complex stuff, but we'll get there one step at a time, right? But still, anta is considered an independent pronoun. If it was the attached pronoun, it would only be the ga version. Okay, go ahead. Other questions before I go on?
Somebody's asking, if we can't say inna with nahnu, then what about when we read inna nahnu nazzalna, for example?
Okay. Inna. Let's see. Let's put that ayah together. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhuna. Okay. That's the ayah, yeah? Mm-hmm. And somebody asked, you said you cannot put nahnu next to inna, but look, I found an ayah in the Quran. It's there. It's not there. What's the harf of nasab?
Harf of nasab?
Yes. What are the harf of nasab?
Inna.
Good. The first one's inna, right?
Inna.
Do you see inna here or inna here?
Inna.
That's not inna.
Yeah.
That's inna plus an alif.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Which means it's not just inna. It's inna and the ism of inna. Remember ismu inna?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Now, what is next to inna? Inna was going to have nahnu next to it. Right?
Yeah.
But you cannot put inna and nahnu. Like I said, you can't put them together. You can only put the nasab version of nahnu there. Mm-hmm. What's the nasab version of nahnu?
Nahnu is na.
Good. Na. And so you have to put those two together. And that becomes what?
Innana.
Innana. And a like a brief or cooler version of saying it is what?
Inna.
Inna, which is what you find in the ayah. Oh, okay. So inna is actually inna plus nahnu, inna plus na together.
Yeah.
Became inna. Yeah. But then separately, there's another nahnu in the ayah. So how many times did Allah use the word we in this ayah? He used it twice. He said, this part doesn't mean certainly. This part means certainly we. And then he said again, we. And then there's a third one, which you'll learn later on. There's another we in here. It's as if Allah said the word we three times. He's saying, without a doubt, we sent down the reminder. You see how Allah is talking?
Yeah.
Like Allah is talking about who sent down the Quran, the reminder. And he says, you think someone else sent that down?
Yeah.
It was me. Who? When does someone talk like that?
When they're angry.
Yeah. And when they're pounding, when they're like making a point that should go like pierce through your heart like an arrow. So he said, no doubt about it. We sent down the Quran. Oof. Oof. And then he says, wa inna, and certainly we just did that one, right?
Yeah.
Lahu lahafidhun. We will guard it, especially. We will be the ones to guard it. You think you can change it? You think you can make it disappear? You think you can eradicate it from the face of the earth? Try me. It's like that from Allah. Like, yeah. It's such a powerful ayah where there's we's multiple times, right? But we recite it like there's no explosions inside the ayah, and we're like, inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. You're like, so nice. Feels good. Yeah, it does. But it's supposed to shake you up because...
So they're supposed to kind of recite it angrily?
No, you're not. But you're supposed to actually appreciate Allah's authority. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. And when you read that, it just dawns on you. What is Allah saying about His Quran? What is Allah saying? And it's so powerful that He didn't say Quran here. He said a dhikra. Is one of the names. Yeah, the reminder. Why? As if Allah is saying, I reminded, and you forget? You realize who's the one sending this reminder? That you can take it lightly? It's not your phone going off reminding you of game time. It's not some small reminder. You think this reminder came from somewhere less important? We're the ones who sent it.
What does he mean by we're?
Like, we?
Yeah.
We is used by Allah when He is describing Himself as a king.
Oh, okay.
Ancient times, the kings used to speak about themselves and say, we have spoken.
Oh, okay.
You dare challenge our empire?
Yeah, because I used to get confused because I used to read like the translation and said, we sent it down. So I
right. Thought, like, now, who is we? How many are there, right? Inshallah, when we get more advanced, we'll discuss we in detail. Okay. When is we used in the Quran? When is I used in the Quran? When is he used in the Quran? We're going to compare all of that.
Okay.
I'm preparing you for really beautiful discussions in the Quran. Like, you know, when I give lectures, Surat Yusuf or khutbahs and things like that, I have to hold back a lot of things that I study because they're not for everybody, because not everybody's studying Arabic, right?
Mm-hmm.
So those of you that are going to put the effort into study, then we can discuss some things that aren't easy to discuss for somebody who doesn't have that background. They'll just be lost, right? But when we open this up, like if I sat there in a lecture and started talking about rafa and nasab and jar and pronoun and
people
this,
would be like,
see you later. That's what your face looks like when I do that sometimes. You're like, right?
Yeah.
That's not fair to them. It's not the place.
Mm-hmm.
But for those of you that will become more, accustomed to learning these things, then I can start sharing some of this stuff with you. That man, when I first studied it, I was like, wow. And you know what it is? I'll tell you something. Let me give you an example. I have a game on my phone. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Let's see. Crossy Road.
Oh.
Crossy Road. Okay? This is the game, right?
Okay.
My high score, by the way, is 660. It's a ridiculous score. Okay, anyway. So this is a game. But behind this game, there's code. The programmer wrote a lot of code.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see the code.
Yeah.
You don't see those permutations. You just see the UX, the screen, the skin on top.
Yeah.
You know, what the user sees is not the programming behind it. when I give a lecture and I talk about this word means this, or this ayah means this, or this is how I would translate it, I'm showing you the screen on top, but I'm not discussing in detail what?
The bottom.
The source code.
Yeah.
The programming code. Mm-hmm. When you guys study this, then we can study the revelation and we can also study the source code of the Arabic and discuss how come we translated this way? How come we wouldn't translate it that way? That's why we're doing this. But it's a fantastic question. And it was an opportunity for me to share with you, again, why this is such a rich study. Learn your pronouns, because a couple of months from now, it'll change your life. It'll absolutely change your life. Pronouns are the backbone of the Arabic language. If Arabic was a building, then the pillar that's holding the whole building together is pronouns. Your rafa pronouns, your attached pronouns, the rules behind the pronouns, meaning the independent ones are rafa, the attached ones can only be nasab or jar. Yeah. Recognizing the pronouns, this is an independent one, this is an attached one. Yeah. The attached one is cousins with the independent one. The independent one is cousins with the attached one. Yeah. Identifying them and then translating the pronouns quickly. Man, that will change your life. You'll get so messed up every time somebody's reciting Quran, you'll be like, what? Oh, what? You're going to hear pronouns all over, yeah, all over the place. Now, one last thing I have to share with you. What's Hua's cousin?
Hua.
Who? What's Huma's cousin?
Huma.
So I'm just going to make a list of the H cousins. Okay. Who? Huma. Hum. Ha. Huma. And Hunna. Those are the cousins, right? Yeah. Those are the first six cousins, mm-hmm, right? The thing with Hu is sometimes Hu is in a good mood and wants to smile. Yeah. So sometimes, even though he's Hu, sometimes he sounds like he.
Yeah. He.
It's still the same thing. It still means it's an attached pronoun. It still means it's cousins with Hua. It still means that it could be Nasab or Jar, because we don't judge these guys by ending sound. But sometimes you'll find Hu and sometimes you'll find
he.
He. Sometimes the other cousin, Huma, is in a good mood and he sounds like Hima.
Hima.
And sometimes Hum is in a good mood and sounds like
Hima.
Him. Ha is always Ha. She's like, I'm already happy, so I don't need to be in a, I'm already in a good mood. So I don't need to worry about me. Huma can sometimes sound like Hima, and Hunna can sometimes sound like
Hinna.
It doesn't change the meaning. It doesn't change the grammar. It just sounds happier sometimes. Okay. That's all it is. So if you keep that in mind, let's listen to the Fatiha. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك
كا
كا What's كا؟
كا is you.
Yes. نعبد وإياك
كا
comes from what original pronoun?
أنت.
Good. كا إياك أنت نستعين إهدي
نس
نا. It's actually na, but then it connects to us. But na comes from where?
Na, it comes from.
Nahnu.
Good, we, nahnu, na. As-sirat al-mustaqim. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alay.
Him.
Him is the happy version of which cousin?
Hum.
Hum.
Hum, yeah.
So then,
right? Ghayr al-maghdubi alay.
Him.
Wala al-dallin. Pronouns in even Surah Al-Fatiha.
So you, like, you can, if you know the pronouns and their meaning, you can like find like one word and like say if it's like they.
Yeah.
That's
okay. And then it starts like popping open. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّي
كَ.
What's ka?
Anta, that's you.
Yeah, you.
You.
Wastaghfir hu.
Who?
He.
That's he.
He. Inna hu.
Who is he?
He. Kana tawwaba. Kana.
He was talking about somebody.
Yeah, he's talking about him.
Oh, him.
He's talking about himself.
Oh, okay.
He's talking about himself. Cool, huh?
Yeah.
Your ears will start getting used to pronouns.
Yeah. That just like unlocked like 10 million things in my brain.
Uh-huh.
Crazy.
That's why I said it's the what? The pillar of Arabic.
Yeah.
Right? Pronouns are the pillar of Arabic. I want you guys to be able to make the most of the last half hour of class today. I was going to do the fragments 4 and 5, but I'm not going to do that. I want you to practice the pronouns some more.
Yeah, okay.
And there's some concepts regarding the pronouns that I want to teach you in the next half hour. So I'm going to give you 7 minutes downtime. recalibrate and come back and we'll finish up strong, okay? Okay. All right, good job.
Wow, that's
you like want to take over for questions.
Oh my gosh, like now I'm so excited.
All right. Let's see. Ariba, class is not over yet. We have 30 minutes left, inshallah. Who was asking? Aisha. There is no change in the meaning if you say who or he. You say who or he depending on what's coming before it. But either way, who and he both mean he. Whom and him both mean them. There's no change in the meaning that way. Inna and nahnu can't be together because inna, remember, is a harf of nasl. That means that whatever comes after it, it has to make that word nasl. And nahnu is always rafa. Nahnu is always rafa. All of the original pronouns are always rafa. We can't make them nasl. That's why we have the attached version. The attached versions can be nasab or jar, but the original versions are always rafa'. So when we want to use inna with a pronoun or any of the other harf nasabs with a pronoun, inna, anna, ka'anna, and so on, same thing with the harf jar, ba'ta, kaf, lam, waw, so on. When we want to use one of those with a pronoun, then we use the attached version. So that's why we don't say inna nahnu, we say inna or innana, because we have to use the nasab or jar version. I hope that answered the question. If we're talking about Shaira, I hope I pronounced the name right. If we're talking about a group of mixed boys and girls, then we always use the masculine version. The feminine version, hunna and antunna, are only used for only girls. If you have even one boy in that group, then you have to use the masculine version. Amna, I didn't understand your question. Merciful soldier, you are correct. Tasmiya, we never want to get used to saying always. There's never going to be a rule that's always the case. There's always exceptions to a rule. So don't try to find things that are always true. We're talking about the things that are mostly true. So kaf at the end, a lot of the time it will be a pronoun, but it won't always be a pronoun. For those of you who still haven't understood inna with nahnu, I think we've gone over it 3 or 4 times. So please go back in the video and just listen to that part again, inshallah, so we don't have to keep explaining it over and over. Muhtasim, you can tell the difference between a cousin pronoun and an original pronoun because the original pronouns will always be by themselves. The cousin pronouns will always be attached to something. Felix, ka cannot change to ki because if you change ka to ki, then you're changing the gender. Ka is masculine. It means you when you're talking to a man or a guy, a boy. But ki is feminine and you use that when you're talking to a girl. Aisha in Alhamdulillahi, that ha is not a pronoun. That is part of the word Allah. The word Allah ends in the letter ha. Abdullah, we use hum and him depending on the sound that comes before it. So if the sound before it is u, then we would use hum. Or if the sound before it is a, we would use hum. We use him when the sound before it is e. So like rabbihim, but we would say rabbahum and rabbuhum. I hope that made sense. For those of you who need to review the pronouns, I believe the table for pronouns is on page 18 of the notes. Page 18 of the notes. So Hana will know for attached pronouns, how can we tell the difference between nasab or jar? We don't know how to do that yet. And that's something that we're going to learn coming up. For those of you still asking about the notes, you should see a link at the bottom of the screen, dreamworldwide.net/study-resource. If you follow that link and you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see a download link for the workbook and the workbook answer key. Also, I see a lot of you guys asking about surahs that Ustad wants you to memorize. Ustad wasn't saying he wants you guys to memorize surahs. He was saying that there are certain concepts that you need to memorize. Like we memorize the Muslim chart, right? Muslimun, Musliman, Muslimin. We also memorize the harf of jar, the harf of nasab, and now we memorize the pronouns. That's what he was referring to. In order to move forward, these things that we're memorizing, you need to know them very, very well. So that's what he was talking about. Imad, pronouns can be used for non-living things, yes. Huda, that is correct. If you see E, then you're going to be using the happy versions for the pronouns. So you could say Rabbihi, you could say Rabbihima, or Rabbihim, or Rabbihin. Yusuf, Siddiqui, yeah, that's fine. You can do that, inshallah. For those of you who want to send pictures and audio and videos, I believe the email for that was arabic@bayina.com.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Bismillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Any outstanding questions, Jawad?
I think we got the main concepts. There's some things that we've already covered a couple of times that are keep coming up, and I tried to address those as well. But the inna with naturally concept is something that came up a couple of times.
Okay. Maybe people missed the recording of it or the part of it that they didn't attend, or yeah, they saw it and they're still confused.
I told them to, I explained it one more time, and then I said to just go back into the recording and look over it. Also, can you say the email one more time for them to send videos to?
Yeah, so the arabic@bayina.com is my email address. So you can send me, a couple of you already sent me actually, what's his name? Zubair? Let me see my phone. Where did I put it? I put it by the table over there. Can you go grab and get it? It's really cool. I believe his name is Zubair. He wrote from Wuhan, China. He's taking the class from there, and he sent me a picture of his notes. So cool. And then somebody sent me, a dad sent me a picture of the whiteboard where he's drawing up all these notes for his kids and his family. So they're learning together. But he didn't tell me where he's from. It's on the table itself, on this one of the sides.
It's not here.
No?
No.
Okay. Just come back then. It's okay. All right. So now we got to wrap this up. And to wrap this up, the concepts that I want to teach you are just making your understanding of pronouns more comprehensive. The assignment you have today is really just mastering page 18. That's all I need from you, is for you to memorize page 18. You need to remember the rules behind it, that they're all rafa. You need to know the attached versions. Hua becomes hu, huma is huma, hum is hum, he is ha, huma is huma, hunna is hunna, anta is ka, antuma kuma, antum kum, anti ki, antuma kuma, antuna kunna, anani, and nahnuna, ani or e, and nahnuna. And the attached ones can only be nasab or jar, right? So those are the few things I want you to just really own before class tomorrow. So that's all I need you to spend your time on. And are the audio files still not available, Jawad?
They're up. They're up under, like, for example, the respective videos, like under day two, we have the Muslim chart audio.
So the pronoun one should be up there, right? Because I did make a pronoun video.
The pronoun one's going to go up today.
Okay, so you guys will see the pronoun audio clip. It's a couple of minute clip or a few seconds clip. Listen to it over and over. Get used to it, inshallah, you'll get there, okay? Now I want to share with you a concept. Let's take the word huwa. What status is it? It's rafa, yeah? And its attached version is hu, okay? When I talk about hu in this lesson, I'm talking about all of the attached pronouns, but I'm only using hu as the example. So whatever I say about hu works for all the cousins. Huma, hum, hunna, ka, kuma, kum, ki, kuma, kunna, ni, I, na. It works for all of them, okay? So here's what I want you to know. We learn harf of jar. Ba, ta, kaf, lam, waw, min, fi, an, ala, hatta, ila. Okay? Now, which pronoun do we talk about? Who, right? Now, the first harf of jar is B. Right?
Yeah.
I can't put huwa next to it because huwa is the original pronoun, the independent pronoun, that's rafa.
Yeah.
I can only use the nasab or jar version because B wants a jar word.
Yeah.
So what's the jar version of huwa? It's huwa. Hu, right? But bihu, say it for me, bihu.
Bihu
is too much work.
Yeah.
So hu, we're going to use the happier version of it.
Bihi.
Bihi. Remember I said hu sometimes sounds like he?
Yeah.
It just sounds nicer this way, in this case. Okay, so bihi is two words. The b part is the harf of jar. The he part is the attached pronoun. Again, I want to explain to you why did we use the attached pronoun? Because the attached pronoun can only be nasab or jar, and b wants something jar. So if you want to put a pronoun next to it, then you better put the attached pronoun. Okay, that's what you're gonna see. Bihi. Bihi is actually two words.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the second word is the majrur. So bihi is also jar majrur. It doesn't look like your regular jar majrur, yeah, but it's still a jar majrur. By the way, what's the cousin of hum?
Hum
is also hum, and sometimes it sounds nicer to say what?
Him.
Him, right? So you could say be him.
Be him.
And then B would be the jar, and the him part would be the majrur. If B means with, and hum means they, right?
With they.
With them.
With them. Oh, okay.
With them. Be him. And now, what's anta? What does anta become? What's the attached version?
Ka.
Ka. So, bika.
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 Yeah.
Okay.
You.
Ba, ta, kaf, lam, right? Lam. You can say laka.
Laka.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Lam is a weird harf of jar. When it comes with every other ism, it has a li on it.
Yeah.
But when you put it with a pronoun, it, you put a la on it. Okay. So, here's how that works. We say alhamdulillahi. We don't say alhamdulillahi. We say alhamdulillahi. This is a jar majrur. The li part is the harf of jar. The word Allah became jar because of it. Oh. Right? But if I wanted to say li and then attach the pronoun huwa, I, of course I can't do huwa anyway. I'm not allowed. I have to use the attached version. Mm-hmm. What's the attached version?
Lihu.
Who? But they don't say li. They say lahu.
Lahu.
The way they pronounce that is what?
Lahu.
Lahu. Now, let me show you another one. We're going to use la now to attach, right? Yeah. What's the attached version of antum?
Kum.
So if I wanted to put, should I say la antum or la kum?
La kum.
That's why we say la kum dinukum waliyadin. La kum dinukum waliyadin. Okay. Now, so let's see fi, right? Fi. Mm-hmm. Now, should I say fi huwa?
No.
What should I say?
Fihu.
Fihu. Fihu. Is that easier?
Fihi.
Fihi.
Oh, fihi, yeah.
Fihi. Okay. Fihi. Or fihima. Or fihim. Whatever pronoun. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Or fikum. Wa'alamu anna fikum Rasulullah. Notice how it's written like it's one word?
Yeah.
Why? Because that literally they're called attached pronouns because they get attached.
Yeah.
Now notice. What are we going to call this? We're going to call this jar
majrur.
Majrur. We're used to calling jar majrur things that look like two words.
Yeah.
But now we're just calling them jar majrur even though they look like one word. This is something you memorized on page 27.
Yeah.
This is something you memorized on page 18, and they kind of came together. Okay, it became jar majrur. Okay. Now, inna.
Inna.
What are inna's cousins? Inna, what else?
Anna.
Ka'anna. Good. Ka'anna.
Bi anna.
Layta. Lakinna. And? La'alla. Right? You can say innahu.
Innahu.
You can say annahu.
Annahu.
You can say ka'annahu.
Bi'annahu.
You can say bi'annahu. You can say laytahu. You can say lakinnahu. You can also say la'allahu yazakkaru aw yakhsha. Aw yakhsha, right? So la'allahu. Now, what is huwa originally from?
The pronouns.
Yeah. Which original pronoun? Which the independent pronoun from huwa. Which it came? Huwa. Huwa. Right. You couldn't use huwa because inna wants what version?
The light, or not the light.
The nasab version, because it's a harf of nasab.
Yeah.
There's a typo in lakinna.
There's a typo in lakinna. Wait, hold on a second. Where's lakinna again? Lakinna. No, you're mistaken. Just pay attention next time. Lakinnahu. Okay. So, innahu, the who
yeah.
is the attached version of huwa. Now, what did I tell you? The independent versions are rafa,
yeah.
and the attached versions can only be
nasab
or jar. The reason you see it like that in Arabic is because inna wants the nasab version.
Yeah.
And the nasab version is who. Now, let me show you this. Do you see an attached pronoun in both of these examples?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
isn't it the case that in one of them is it attached to a harf of jar, and in the other one it's attached to a harf of nasab?
Yeah.
Didn't you learn that the attached pronoun could be nasab or jar?
Yeah.
But you know for sure which one is this and which one is this.
Yeah.
This one is what status?
Jar majrur.
So therefore it's jar.
Yeah.
And this one is ism inna.
Ism who?
So ism. Remember inna and ism inna?
Ism who?
I remember it back
then. Ism inna, yeah.
Inna, ism inna, yeah. Ism whatever got beat up and made nasab is called ism inna. Ismu inna.
Ismu inna.
Right? Yeah. So the who part is nasab because it's getting beat up by inna. It's the ismu inna, right? So even though they look the same, who and who, one of them is jar and the other one is nasab.
Yeah,
oh, so yes, this who is, you're right, this is jar majrur and this is inna and ismu inna, but the pronoun itself, the who part, one of them is jar and the other one is nasab.
Yeah.
So how do you tell if a pronoun is nasab or jar? Depends what it got attached to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right? If it's attached to a harf of jar, it's jar. If it's attached to a harf of nasab,
it's nasab.
It's nasab. But here's the last one. Remember the word kitab?
Yeah.
Okay. You need extra brain juice for this one now. This is really the reason I wanted to dedicate a half hour at the end to this.
Okay.
Pay attention to this part, okay? How many words do you see?
I see two.
Good. Kitab and ka.
Yeah.
Kitab and ka. Good. What kind of word is ka?
Ka is a rafa.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ka.
It's jar.
Ka. No, it's not a harf of jar. It's an attached pronoun.
Oh, yeah.
The harf of jar come in the beginning. This is attached at the end, right?
Yeah.
If it's attached at the end, it's got to be from page 18.
Yeah.
So what is the original anta. Of ka?
Anta.
Anta. What does anta mean?
You.
Good. What status could ka be?
Rafa. No, nasab jar.
The original ones, the independent ones are?
Rafa.
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 Okay, so are you in agreement if I say over here, this could be nasab or jar? The ka part.
Yes.
Just the ka part,
mm-hmm.
right? I'm not talking about the whole thing. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let me ask you this. Kitabu. Is it light?
Kitabu. Yes.
Yeah, that's light. Kitabu, does it have al on it?
No.
That means kitabu might be a
mudaf.
Okay. What is the definition of mudaf? The word that comes before the of. Right? And the rules for the mudaf are it's light and it doesn't have al. But you can never call something a mudaf until you can show that the next word is
mudaf
ilay. Well, what's the next word? Ka.
Oh, ka, yeah.
The next word is ka.
Yeah.
Could ka be, and if ka is a mudaf ilay, what's the question we should ask it?
Is it jar?
Right, is it jar? Well, it's an attached pronoun.
So
an attached pronoun can only be
nasab or jar.
So could it be?
Yes.
And what did we say about could it be?
It has to be mudaf.
Right. So that would mean that the kitabu part is mudaf and the ka part is mudaf ilay because they both meet the conditions, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's the definition of mudaf, the word before the of?
Book of.
What's the definition of mudaf ilay, the word?
Book of you.
Which means book of yours.
Oh, yeah.
Which means simple English. What's another way of saying book of yours?
Book
of yours.
This is your book.
Your book.
Oh, your book, yeah.
This is how you say your book. Kitabuka, your book.
Kitabuka.
Okay. Now let me give you the shortcut. This was the long explanation. I'm going to give you the long explanation again. I'll give you a different example and give you this explanation again. Or instead of, because we've been doing who a while, the surah Buna. Okay? How many words do you see?
Two.
Rabbu and?
Na.
Okay. The na came from what you memorized today.
Yeah.
What does it, is this the original version? Is this the independent version? Or is this the attached version?
Attached.
Okay, what is this the attached version of?
Nahnu.
When you see an attached version, what could be the status?
Nasab
or jar.
Good. The na could be, from what you know, nasab or jar. We're in agreement so far?
Yeah.
Okay. The first word, does it look like a mudaf?
Yeah.
Light?
Mm-hmm.
No al.
Yeah.
Right? The second word, could it be jar?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That means that this is a mudaf and a? Mudaf. Okay, now when you have a mudaf and mudaf ilayh, you put of in between?
Yes.
If Rab means master, and na is the attached version of what word again? I forgot.
You.
You.
No. No.
We.
We.
Master of we.
Is that English? Master of we?
No.
No.
Master of what?
Master of us.
Master of ours.
Oh, ours. Yeah.
What's an easier way to say that in English? Master of ours.
Master of ours.
What's an easier way to say that? Oh. Normal way of saying that.
Our Lord.
Our Master.
Our Master. Oh, yeah.
Simple. Our Master. This is a mudaf and a mudaf ilayh, and the meaning would be our master. Okay. Now, here's the rule. Here's the shortcut. I did all this like it's the attached version. It could be nasab or jar. Look at the first word, and then blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Right? Now we tie it all together. Yeah. We say... Bina. We say innana, and we say rabbuna. I'm going to give you three examples. Do they all have na in them?
Yes.
Okay. This one has na in it. This one has na in it. And this one has na in it. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this first one has a harf of jar.
Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
The second one has a harf of nasab. Is that clear?
Yes.
This third one has an ism. Rab is an ism.
Yeah.
Person, place, thing, idea, adjective, adverb, or more. Ism. Yeah. So the na was attached to a harf of jar.
Mm-hmm.
The na was attached to a harf of nasab.
Mm-hmm.
And the na was attached to an
ism.
We know three possibilities of where we can find it attached so far.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What do you know about na? It's attached, right?
Yeah.
So what could the answer be to its status? Let me put this in a table so this becomes even clearer. I think I removed the table tab. I'll bring it back later. Let's do bina.
Okay.
The na could be nasab or jar, right?
Yeah.
But I know for sure which one it is right now.
Mm-hmm.
Which one is it right now?
It's jar.
Definitely jar. Yeah. Why?
Because of the B.
And what will I call this thing that I see right now? Excellent. I'm going to call it jar. Majroor. Is that clear?
Yeah.
So bina is jar majroor. Mm-hmm. You clear about that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then I said innana.
Yeah.
That was the second one,
yeah.
Right? And I colored the na because it's the attached pronoun. And I remind myself again, the na could be nasab or jar. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But in this case, what is it attached to?
Nasab.
It's a half of nasab.
Yeah.
So it's the ismu inna.
Ismu, yeah.
So the na would be the ismu inna, and therefore the jar is gone.
Yeah.
Clear? It's still the same na and bina and inna na, but there's a difference.
Yeah.
Okay. And what about the last one was rabbuna.
Rabbuna.
That was the third one, yeah. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Again, the same na. And the na we already said over and over again. Could be nasab or?
Jar.
Nasab or jar. But I went through this exercise and said rabbu looks like a mudaf.
Yeah.
And this looks like a? Mudaf ilayh. Therefore, the nasab is gone.
Yeah, so it becomes just jar.
So this one will be called a mudaf and it won't be called jar majrur.
Yeah,
no.
Mudaf and mudaf ilayh.
It will be called mudaf and mudaf ilayh.
Yeah.
Okay, now let's go back. Bina, innana, and rabbuna. Right?
Yeah.
This one is jar majrur.
Yes.
This one is inna and ismu inna.
Yes.
And this one is mudaf and mudaf ilayh. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
Now let me tell you something about this last one, the mudaf and mudaf ilayh. Whenever you have an ism, anytime in Arabic you have an ism,
mm-hmm.
and you have a pronoun,
mm-hmm.
ism and an attached pronoun.
Mm-hmm.
Is this an ism and an attached pronoun?
Yeah.
You don't have to go through the whole process. You can just say it's definitely 1,000,000% mudaf and mudaf ilayh.
So if it has an ism?
Ism and pronoun? Mudaf, mudaf ilayh. Done. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Okay?
Yeah.
Ism and pronoun? Mudaf, mudaf ilayh. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan
abduhu.
Is abd means slave. Is that a person?
Yeah.
No.
A slave is not a person?
It is a person.
We are Allah's slaves. Are we persons?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, so is this a slave of a person?
Yeah.
So it's an ism, because a person is an ism.
Yeah.
Is this an attached pronoun? Who?
Yes.
That's a mudaf mudaf ilayh. Which means that pronoun can only be jar.
Jar.
Because a mudaf ilayh can only be?
Jar.
Don't forget, The sound does not make it rougher. Why not? Because pronouns be crazy. You don't tell if they're rafa nasab or jar by the way they sound. The only way to tell them rafa nasab or jar is how they are, meaning are they independent or are they attached? Mm-hmm. Now we saw three kinds of attachments. We attach them to the harf of jar, mm-hmm. bika. We attach them to a harf of nasab, yeah. innaka. And we attach them to an ism, kitabuka, mm-hmm. or masjiduka. Masjid is an ism, it's a place, right? Masjiduka.
Yeah.
Or ustaduka.
That's a person.
Yeah, ustad is a teacher, right?
Yeah.
So, bika, this is jar majroor. Mm-hmm. This is inna and ismu inna.
Yeah.
And this one is what? Mudaf and?
Mudaf
ilay. And so then of goes in between them. You know what masjid means? You know what ka means? What's an easy translation of masjiduka?
Masjid of...
ka.
Masjid of him.
No, not him. It's not him.
No, masjid
him would be huwa, right?
Yeah. So
that would be who? Masjid
of you.
Is that good English? Masjid of you?
Your masjid.
Yeah, your masjid.
Yeah.
Your masjid. Inna means for sure.
Yeah.
Innaka means for sure you.
For sure you.
B means with. Bika means what?
With you.
With you.
With you.
With you.
Bik with you.
Bik with you. So, three situations. It's attached to a harf of jar, it's attached to a harf of nasab, or it's attached to an ism. When it's attached to an ism, 1,000,000%, it's a mudaf and a mudaf ilay. It's a mudaf and mudaf. The ism part is the mudaf, and the pronoun part is the mudaf ilay. I'll take questions for the last 5 minutes. Chuad? Oh, you're muted.
I'm still looking for questions.
Okay.
This is second my brain juice. I don't even know how to do school now. I'm dry.
This is school.
No, like other school.
How do you say fee with? What does it say?
How do you say fee with? Oh no, there's too many messages.
How do you say fee with
in Anna?
With Anna. Oh. So Anna is I, and the attached version is ni or e, right? Mm-hmm. And then fi, if you want to attach it, you attach the jar version,
yeah.
which is another ya, so it becomes fiya.
Fiya.
But that's, you know, that? Yeah, you can say fiya, yeah.
What is that, fiya?
In me.
In me? Oh.
Yeah, there's two ya's. It's a weird example, but it'll happen rarely.
Thank you, sir.
Somebody asked, in Masjiduka, why is Masjid Rafa?
Oh, it doesn't matter. I chose to make it Rafa here, Masjiduka. But if Masjid... I keep missing the dal. Masjiduka. And I'll repeat that. I'll copy that over. Masjidaka. And I'll make this one Masjidaka. That's a really good question and good review for you too. So let's end with this question. Everybody pay full attention to this question and forget about your question. Your question now became less important. This question became more important because this will benefit each of you. Okay, so please listen carefully. I'm writing three versions right now. Masjiduka, Masjidaka, and Masjidika, right?
Mm-hmm.
The ka is still the same. Masjid still meets my conditions for mudaf in all cases. It's always got light no alif lam, light no alif lam, light no alif lam. So they're all mudaf mudaf ilay every time, yeah. right? And the ka is a mudaf ilay, so the ka is the attached pronoun that's jar, jar, and jar, which means the translation is your masjid, and your masjid. It's the same translation. Yeah. So then what's the point of making it masjiduka versus masjidaka versus masjidika? Listen to this. Your masjid offered a new program. Okay?
Okay.
I visited your masjid. The color of your masjid is white. Three sentences, right? Okay. Now think about the English. What's the fi'il? In the first one.
Offered.
Good. Who's doing it?
The masjid.
Your.
Am I offering?
No,
in the first masjid. Sentence?
Masjid.
Who's offering? Who's masjid. Doing the act of offering?
Masjid.
Oh, the masjid?
Masjid's offer. Yeah. The masjid offered a new program. So masjid must be rafa.
Yeah.
then I would say masjiduka, because you have to make it rafa, because it's doing the offering.
Yeah.
I visited your masjid. Who's doing the act of visiting?
I.
Where am I? What am I visiting?
Masjid.
Masjid is a detail.
Oh, your masjid.
Your masjid is a detail, isn't it?
That's nasab.
So that the masjid will have to be nasab masjidaka.
Masjidaka. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The color of
your
masjid. Yeah. Of, after of. Whatever's after of has to be what?
Harf.
No, whatever's after of has to be jar.
Jar, oh yeah.
So I'd have to say masjidika. Because it's after of. This one would be red. Masjid offered. That's why the status changes. It could be the doer, it could be the detail, or it could be after of. The mudaf will change. The mudaf ilay will stay jar all the time. But the mudaf could be rafa or nasab or jar as needed. Depends on what somebody's saying. When Allah wants to make the mudaf rafa, He will make it rafa. When He wants to make it nasab, He will make it nasab. When He wants to make it jar, He will make it jar, depending on what's being said. Okay? Jawad, any other relevant questions before I call it a day?
Can we have an idafa with an independent pronoun?
No, you can never have an idafa with an independent pronoun. What did you say?
When are we going to like open up a mushaf and like read?
When are we going to open up a mushaf and read? After tomorrow.
After tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah.
So day 8?
Well, no. Tomorrow's day 7 already?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What are we going to do, fi'il, man?
Day 6?
So it's already day 6. We're two days behind now.
Wow.
2 days behind what I usually teach. But again, I'm not rushing this. It's all good with me. I'm good.
It's all good, homie.
It is absolutely good. I might even teach an extra day or two and change up the schedule a little bit.
Okay.
I don't know. We'll see. But I do want to finish all the material, but I don't want to rush through all the material. So yeah. I think tomorrow we can finish up all of ism comfortably. So that'll be day 7 finishing ism. And I do need at least 3 days for fi'il, at least. So that would be 8, 9, and 10.
Mm-hmm.
So we could still probably finish on time. Actually, it's a 9-day course. I call it 10-day to give myself an extra day.
Okay.
But I think we should be able to finish comfortably. If not, maybe we'll add an extra day. But I won't make that call yet. Any other questions? So yeah, independent pronouns can never be part of a mudaf mudaf ilayh. That's never going to happen.
Are attached pronouns proper, or is it only independent pronouns?
All pronouns are proper. Good question. Okay.
For ism, for harf nasab and its ism, can the long distance relationship go past the ayah, or will it always be contained in an ayah?
To my knowledge, I can't think of an example where it's outside the ayah. It's possible, but I can't think of an example where it's outside the ayah. No. It's usually very coherent and easy to understand.
So what transcript do you want us to read, day 5?
I want you to read up to day 5, yeah. I want you to read up to day 5, and I want you to really just master page 18. That's all I need for tomorrow. And then we can finish up ism tomorrow, inshallah. Not too much work left with ism. And then fi'il is like party time. Fi'il is like...
easy peasy.
Oh my God. Not even lemon squeeze. Lemon squeezy is too hard for fi'il. Fi'il is like...
easy.
Nothing. And when you conquer ism, fi'il is like, what? What is this? This is a joke. Fi'il.
Yeah.
It's like that. Okay, but ism is the real work. And what you're doing by tomorrow is actually quite a bit of work. It's quite a bit of work. So just, you know, put your head down, focus on the day's work. Don't worry about review and I need to remember everything. You don't need to remember everything. It's okay when we do a review. It's all going to come back. Right now, you just need to understand it, even if it's not solidified and you can recall it like I recall it. Right? I've been teaching it many years, so I can recall it. Jawad's graduated from the program, so he can recall it. But for you to be able to recall it so easily is not going to happen right now. But it will. It will. And I have this program. Let me tell you just a few things. It'll take 60 seconds. My goal is, I keep saying my goal is to take my time and take my time and take my time. Let me tell you, my goal is these two kids are going to, in a sense, determine the pace of the program along with you. So if I feel like they need more time on something and your questions tell me that you need more time on something, then I'll slow it down and take more time on something. That's just what we're gonna do, right? So I'm not in a rush to finish the book or be done by next Ramadan or whatever. My goal is to kind of do a before and after with these two, you know, zoo animals that I have over here, right? The before and after is the first day they're in a certain place, and how far can we get them at the end of the dream curriculum, at the end of the teaching and the reading curriculum, how far can we take them? And then inshallah ta'ala, then we'll start Quran studies. And my goal eventually, you guys know that I do tafsir lectures, right? Mm-hmm. Then I'm going to start using these kids to actually read tafsirs. And so you're going to read this tafsir, you're going to read this. A day will come when these kids, not too far in the future, they're going to read the tafsir and they're going to summarize what Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said about this ayah for me. Or this one, I'll give them two different tafsirs to read up on, and they're going to summarize it for me. Because I need TAs for my tafsir work too. And people to do some work, right? So I'm going to turn them into henchmen. Arabic studies and Quran studies, henchmen and women, right? And that will, and I'll film all of that. I want to film all of that so you guys see their progress. The other cool thing that I think is really cool, that's on the horizon once the schedule tapers down after the intensives, is I plan on taking some courses myself in Arabic to further my own Arabic studies and my own Quran studies, and I'm going to film those too. So you're going to see me not only as a teacher, but you're also going to see me struggling as a student, because at the end of the day, we're all students. So inshallah, with that, I conclude for today. All the best to you with your pronouns. Do a lot of dhikr of them, and if you're having a hard time remembering them, do dhikr of Allah. Allah will make that easy for you. Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antum antum, anti antum antunna, ana nahnu. Huwa becomes who, huma is huma, hum is hum, he is ha, huma is huma, hunna is hunna, anta is ka, antuma kuma, antum kum, anti ki, antuma kuma, antunna kunna, ana is near e, nahnu is na. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Barakallahu wa lakum fil Quran al-Hakim.
Closer. Barakallahu li wa lakum.
Barakallahu li
wa lakum.